It is a classic rivalry, a series defined by its history and tradition, featuring the long gray line of cadets and the brigade of midshipmen, two military academies who are synonymous with excellence. And today, live from Philadelphia, CBS Sports is proud to present Army-Navy, the 106th edition of this storied series. Army ready to go on the field here at Lincoln Financial. The Black Knights, here they come. Their confidence is at a season high after losing their first six games this season and come in having won four in a row for their annual matchup with the Naval Academy. And the midshipmen onto the field. Navy go to its third consecutive bowl game, the Poinsettia Bowl in San Diego. And we welcome you inside the broadcast booth. Ian Eagle along with Boomer Esiason. Great to be with you once again for Army-Navy. This is a matchup that has been dominated by Navy the last 3 years, Boomer. But for Army, second year under Bobby Ross, they feel like they've closed the gap. There's finally a little bit of optimism going around.
And there should be. They've won four in a row, first time since 1996. And Bobby Ross's transformation of the West Point football program is fully underway. But today they're playing for something very special. It's not has anything to do with the BCS. It's all about the Commander-in-Chief's Trophy. For the first time since 1996, both of these academies will be had the honor to play for because they both beat Air Force to identical scores, 27-24. And for the Army seniors, it's all about taking this trophy home. It'll be a great way to end their season. And for the Navy seniors, it's all about keeping it for the third straight year, which would be a record.
Now remember, for the Navy seniors, they have a chance to sweep Army. First time that the seniors will have done that since 1977. All the action coming up here on CBS.
Between my two phone bills, it's probably about $60 a month.
About $150.
Probably $100 a month.
With Vonage, you get unlimited calls to anywhere in the U.S. and Canada, and all the cool features you could ever want are included. And it's just $24.99 a month. Call 1-800-972-4866 and get your first month free. This offer is also available online and at these fine retailers. Vonage, leading the internet phone revolution.
This holiday, how will you give her as much joy as she has given you?
Mom likes it.
With a Bulova watch from Kay Jewelers.
Wow, she really likes it.
And you can be assured of two things. Kay always has the latest Bulova styles, and she'll absolutely love it.
I think they're gonna kiss now.
I think you're right.
Every kiss begins with K.
Lincoln Financial Field is the venue here in Philadelphia. Weather conditions today, temperature 38 degrees. Mostly sunny skies expected the rest of the afternoon. And the series history, this is how close it's been. They are tied at 49-49-7. Navy with a lopsided victory a year ago, 42-13. And the Army-Navy game in HDTV, sponsored by Prudential Financial. Let's go downstairs, check in with the third member of our broadcast team, Dwayne Ballin.
Ian, Boomer mentioned the Commander and Chief's Trophy. It was stolen earlier this week from the Navy locker room. A note was left behind, and I'm paraphrasing here. Before we win the game, we will take the trophy. By the time you read this, It will be halfway along the way to West Point. Well, 48 hours later, it was found at Bancroft Hall, and it is back now here on the Navy sideline. Investigation ensued. We are told forensics have implicated some cadets. But there's another school of thought, gentlemen, that possibly some midshipmen are behind this. Conspiracy theorists are loving this, guys.
Well, I think there's a new CBS show in play here, CSI Annapolis. We got to get to the bottom of this. Army is going to kick it off to Navy. Justin Koenig will do the honors for the Black Knights. And Reggie Campbell is the return man for the midshipmen. Koenig, a high school soccer player, All-State in Pennsylvania. And we're underway the 106th meeting of America's Classic. Return man Campbell up the middle. Breaks through and tripped up. Oh, that looked like it was going to be a big gainer. Turns out to be 27 yards on the return for Campbell. For Navy, entering action at 6-4 this season. And their quarterback, Lamar Owens. He was a patient young man, waited his turn behind Craig Candido and Aaron Polanco, and has guided this Navy team, Boomer, to their third straight bowl game.
Well, he runs this spread option, and I mean, it's all about decision making for him. It's not in the passing game, it's in the running game. Does he give it to the fullback? Does he keep it? Does he pitch it? As we'll find out right here.
Fake on the pitch, and Owens is going to throw it, or is he? Owens able to break free and across the 45-yard line for a first down. Luke Pell and Caleb Campbell combined to bring him down. Right now, let's take a look at our BP starting lineups for the Naval Academy across that line. Pritchett, Galleon, Rossi, Harper, and Green. Just one senior, and that's Marshall Green from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Backs and receivers, Nelson, Campbell, Ballard, the fullback, Yokaitis, and Tomlinson, the wide receivers. On the toss, it's Marco Nelson through a lane. And that'll go for 13 yards and another Navy first down. Barrett Scruggs making the play. Let's look at the Army defense. Wright, Fusco, Lotz, and Craig. Seth Lotz is the senior from Richmond, Virginia. Linebackers, Pell, Schrode, and Scruggs. And in the secondary, Stiff, Davis, seniors, Campbell, a sophomore, and Deion Tarver, the senior from San Antonio, Texas. Two plays, two good runs for Navy to open up. And from the 40-yard line, it's the big man, Adam Ballard, trying to take it up the gut. And he picks up 4 yards. Ballard is in for the injured Matt Hall, who tore his ACL and MCL in that loss to Notre Dame.
And Ian, you were talking about the way that Navy has opened this game. A very impressive kickoff return, too. And I know that Bobby Ross wanted to get his defense out on the field, try to control this Navy offense. And again, it goes back to making sure that you are an assignment football player on defense. Just stick to your assignments. Don't look into the backfield and be deceived.
On a 2nd and 6 now from the 36 for Navy. Just underway here. Long count. Owens, first man through again. And Adam Ballard will pick up a couple. Cameron Craig, first man there. Well, what a week it's been for Paul Johnson in his 4th year at Navy. He's done an incredible job turning this program around. But he's had a back injury that he's been suffering through, got a flat tire earlier in the week, going to the Army-Navy luncheon, never made it there. And here he is today on the sideline once again, looking for his 4th straight win over Army.
And don't forget that CIC trophy was stolen from their locker room.
Good point. And do we take this as an omen of some sort? Navy is trying to prove it otherwise. Freeze option. Here's Owens. Nobody to pitch to. And he is buried. Luke Pell, the hard-hitting linebacker from Burnett, Texas, with a stick.
And we were talking about assignment football. Watch the Army defense kind of flow over the top. Nobody's overreacting. Everybody's staying right at the line of scrimmage, forcing Owens to keep the football. That's exactly what you want to do. We talked to Bobby Ross. He said, keep those guys in the net. Keep Ballard, keep Owens in the net, keep him in front. And there is Bobby Ross, who's done a great job with this offense and defense, especially the defense the last 4 weeks.
Well, they're in that area of the field where they're going to go for it on 4th down, a 4th and 6 from the 36. Owens tosses it back. Matt Pritchett eligible. And Pritchett doesn't get there. Cameron Craig with the stop. It turns out to be a rush for Pritchett.
Now Pritchard goes 6'2", 267 pounds. Take a look at this right here. As Owen rolls right, throws back against the grain, and the big man tries to run with the football. Not the guy that I would want to throw it to in that situation.
The junior from Grove City, Ohio, comes up short. And Army takes over on downs here in the first.
The new Jeep Grand Cherokee SRT8. With the power to go from 0 to 60 in under 5 seconds. It's a force of nature.
Okay, when we're all done, I'm calling Mom, Mom calls Glenn, Glenn calls Kim.
I'm calling him.
Glenn calls Kim.
Who's calling me?
I'm calling you.
And I'm calling him.
Exactly. Good.
Wait.
What?
We don't have cell phones.
I don't have a cell phone.
Actually, I don't have a cell phone either.
This holiday, surprise someone in your family with this amazing LG camera phone with flash and speakerphone and get a second one free. Two great gifts for one great price. Call us, visit us online, or stop by a Verizon Wireless communications store.
Everyone know who they're calling?
No.
Great.
Verizon Wireless.
Save us, and the women who save them.
Every person who knows one more piece of information could get our husbands killed.
Welcome to the unit.
From the Army Corps of Engineers, headquartered in Baghdad, Iraq.
Sir, you have an urgent phone call from Lieutenant Patton.
Lieutenant, Stevens here. You know what to do.
Yes, sir, will do, sir.
Crush it!
You know, who knew they were method actors? They get into these spirit spots.
Well, they really do, and Bobby Ross told us that the morale, not only of his, the whole school at West Point, but also the morale of the troops over in Baghdad and Afghanistan, ride heavily on this game. They want their Army brethren to win this football game, so the morale is high.
And the Black Knights take over on offense. First time today, a first and 10 of the 34 for Army. After Navy turned it over on downs. First play from scrimmage, handoff to Carlton Jones, and he had no room to work with. Just a one-yard gain as Tyler Tidwell was there to make the play. Quarterback for Army, the senior, his final game for the Black Knights. It's Zach Domin, and Boomer, the big key this year. They just asked him to manage the game as opposed to in previous years where they needed him to go out and win it for them through the air.
Right, they're not asking him to throw the ball 30 times a game, and if you remember in this game last year, Army got down quickly. He threw a lot, threw a few interceptions, and the game got out of hand. Bobby Ross said, we're not going to do that anymore, and told Kevin Ross, our offensive coordinator, simplify it and give it to Carlton Jones.
And a three-receiver set on a second and 9 from the 35. And off, it's Jones again. Jones trying to break through that hole, cannot. And limited to a 2-yard gain. Tidwell and Biles collaborate. Take a look at the Army Black Knight offense across the line. Zelenak, Evans, Beer, Wisner, and Conan, two seniors up the middle. Backs and receivers, Carlton Jones, a senior, Mike Vitti, Hill, Trimble, and the senior tight end, Jared Ulikowski from Katy, Texas. So it sets up a 3rd and 7 for the Black Knights from the 37. Wesley now in the backfield. He's been their 3rd down back and more. Former wide receiver shifts to the outside. Here's Domin. Deep drop for him. Domin will throw on the money to Ulikowski. And a 1st down for Army.
We talked about Zach Domin making big plays, and right here, this is a big play for them, keeping the drive going.
Take a look at the Navy defense. They play that 3-4 set. Up front, Chase, Silk, and Chan. Linebackers, Mahoney, Caldwell, Biles, and Tidwell in the secondary. Little, McGown, Price, and Thrasher. New set of downs for Army to work with. First and 10 from the 45. Contact before the ball was snapped. John Chan was trying to jump on the snap count. Chan, a junior out of De La Salle High School.
Prior to the snap, false start, 88 offense.
Yeah. Ulikowski is the one that brought him offsides. Well, we've spared no expense. We've broken out boom with a view to break down this matchup.
Well, Lamar Owens has to be on for Navy when they have the football because he has all those decisions that he has to make in the running game. And the D-line has got to protect the linebackers of Army so they can flow and make the tackles. Of course, when Army has the football, don't panic. Play smash-mouth football straight up the field, and then Navy has to control Carlton Jones. It's as simple as that.
Now a first and 15 from the 40 after the penalty on the tight end. Here's Dobbin on the give to Wesley and runs into a wall. Rob Caldwell was the first man there. A junior from St. John, Indiana, who learned under Bobby McLaren and Lane Jackson, outstanding linebackers in their own right. Caldwell makes the play.
And when we talked to Paul Johnson, the head coach of Navy, yesterday, he was telling us that one of the reasons that Army is so much better is that they really stuck with the run game on offense, that it's not trying to force the issue, asking your players to do something that they're not capable of. And running the ball also keeps the other team's offense off the field, so your defense catches the blow as well.
Second and 15 now for Army at their own 40-yard line. Here's Dahmer. Swings it to the outside. Catch made by Trimble. And then tossed out of bounds. Speedy receiver. Sophomore from Ashburn, Virginia. Greg Thrasher, a fellow sophomore, had the coverage. How about Dahmer? What have you seen here? We talked to him. He said, hey, my focus this week, I want to have my best game in my last game as a collegiate player.
Well, when we talked to Kevin Ross, they took the seven-step drop out of the game plan. They do a lot of bootlegs with him, a lot of three-step drops and five-step drops, get the ball out of his hands quickly, and he manages the game. And the analogy that I would use in the NFL would be Jake Plummer with the Denver Broncos. A very good football player, but has the propensity to throw interceptions. So you manage the game as you coach the player who's on the field, and I think that's what Kevin Ross has done with Zach Dahmer.
This is a third and 7. Can Dahmer get the first down? He can! Perfect pass to Jacob Murphy, who has come back from a collarbone injury. And Murphy hauls it in a new set of downs for Army.
And watch Dahmer right here. He plants his fifth step and throws it on time. So the linebacker does not have a chance to get out underneath the football, and it's a perfectly thrown ball. Look at this. Boom. Out of his hands quickly. That's exactly what Kevin Ross and Bobby Ross have been working with Zach Dahmer on.
Now, great story for Murphy, a senior out of El Paso, Texas. Injured that collarbone for the third straight year against Iowa State. Hasn't played since that matchup and gets to play in his final game here today against Navy. Double tight end set. Dahmer off play action. And a near mistake there. Fortunately for Army, it was incomplete. Jeremy Chase is the one that applied the heat on Zach Dahmer.
And normally when Army runs these bootlegs, he'll have a personal protector come out with him, but on this particular play, they don't have that. And Chase comes unblocked, and Dahmer does a smart thing. He actually gets rid of the football. Does not lead to an interception, but now you want to see how your young quarterback reacts after taking a hit like that that Chase just gave him.
Chase, former linebacker, one of the co-captains on this Navy team. He'll be going into surface warfare after he graduates.
What is this out here?
Little different. Three receiver set on a second and 10. Hand off, and Wesley is caught by Tidwell. The junior from Edmond, Ohio. Good pursuit. Well, for Army, got off to that terrible start, 0-6, but look how they've turned it around in all categories.
Well, this is it right here. That's it right there. Running the football, that's what makes a difference. It keeps your defense off the field. You're controlling the line of scrimmage. You're controlling the clock. And this is a situation right here now where Zach Dahmer's got to be careful. Do not force the issue. You can play field position with Navy. That's okay. Just do not throw an interception here.
Ninth play of the drive on a third and 12. Army is in Navy territory. There's Dahmer looking to throw. Pocket holds up, throws just offline for Trimble. and would have had a first down for the Black Knights if the ball was put to the spot.
Wait a minute now here. As a former quarterback, I'd like to see that ball be caught by Trimble, don't you think? I mean, every now and again, the guy's got to make a play for you.
Yeah, it's
you know, you guys always think these quarterbacks are playing like in a phone booth, like there's nobody around you.
It is a variety of perspectives, you're right. You bring a different take, there's no doubt.
Trimble should have made that catch for a first down.
Owen Tolson, the punter. And Tomlinson is the return man. Gonna let this one bounce. They have a chance. And they save it. Army has pinned Navy back to the 1 yard line. Kenny Rackers on special teams. And Darren Newsett able to down the football after the 42 yard punt by Tolson. First quarter action continues. Army Navy on CBS.
I'm Dale Earnhardt Jr. Welcome to a new generation of Wrangler.
New fits, new comfort, new styles. Wrangler Jeans Company, a new generation of Wrangler. New fits, new comfort, new styles.
Life offers a simple formula for long-term success. Protect what really matters. Grow it with care. That's our approach to planning for your future at Prudential Retirement. For decades, we've used our strength to help people and organizations plan for retirement with intelligent retirement solutions designed to both grow wealth and protect it. Growth and protection. The strong and steady approach to retirement at Prudential Financial.
Two fugitive princes. One wants to free his people. The other to dominate them. One seeks justice. The other seeks power. The trouble is, they're the same man. One warrior, two souls. Prince of Persia, the Two Thrones. Available now. Rated M for mature.
Big time bowl bids are on the line. The Georgia Bulldogs battle the LSU Tigers for the SEC Championship on CBS Sports.
The Home Depot College Football on CBS is sponsored by Jeep, the official vehicle of the 106th Army-Navy game.
Back here in Philadelphia, scoreless at the 7:50 mark first quarter. Jeep is proud to participate in Operation Gratitude, a nonprofit organization dedicated to providing comfort items to troops overseas. Now, this holiday season, Operation Gratitude will be sending its 1,000th care package to our troops all over the world. Operation Gratitude's mission: put a smile on service members' faces, lift morale, and express the appreciation of the American people for the men and women defending our freedom. And great reaction here in the city of brotherly love, aptly named, as part of Operation Gratitude.
Yeah, Philadelphia does a great job here. This stadium is sold out. It is full, and a lot of optimism on the side of Army as they come off of a four-game winning streak, their first since 1996. And this is what you want to do. You want to play field position. They played it right. A great punt and great cover by the Army special teams.
And a first and 10 for Navy from the one. Owens will keep it himself and driven backwards, able to pick up 3 yards on first down. Kaysen Schrode and Luke Pell, a pair of linebackers, leading that charge. Well, the fullback position, Boomer, Adam Ballard is in for Matt Hall. We told you about that. And for Ballard, only a sophomore, Paul Johnson has been tough on him because he believes in his potential. Yes?
Well, that's what Adam Ballard says. I mean, he's been getting screamed at quite a bit in practice, but it's all about keeping your hat level low. And I guess Adam tends to run a little bit high, as you see right here.
Ballard trying to bang his way on the interior. And he gains 3 yards. Cameron Craig in on that stop for Army.
Now, Paul Johnson really does believe that this kid's got the skills, but he wants him to run lower. Remember Kyle Echol last year? His pad level was so much lower than the tacklers, and he would run over guys. And sometimes when you're upright like that, you'll take shots to the chest, and obviously you're absorbing the blow as opposed to delivering it.
Well, Ballard was a high school tailback out of Louisville, Texas. Actually played some wide receiver in high school. How that could be at 6'1", 240, who knows? Trying to rush for the first down. It's Ballard again.
I think he's got it, and that was a nice job by Ballard. A little extra effort. Remember, he walked into the meeting with us, and I said, you kind of do look a little like Kyle Eckel. And he got mad at me.
Yeah, he did get angry.
He says, you know, I know Kyle Eckel is a great player, but I don't want to be the second coming of Kyle Eckel. I want to be the first coming of Adam Ballard. So
I think your point also was physically.
He looks like a fullback. Like, yeah, he has no neck, short arms, big shoulders. I mean, that's what fullbacks look.
Now, I think Adam thought you were saying the comparison facially, and that we'll have to let him and Kyle work through those problems.
Well, just short. Look at this.
Did not get it.
Well, now here you go if you're Paul Johnson. I know that they have the best running attack in all of college football.
They do.
Average over 386 yards a game. So I'll tell you what, he's going to elect to go for it. It'll be interesting to see whether or not he snaps it or whether or not he tries to draw the Army defense offside. But this is a dangerous, dangerous move right here by Paul Johnson. Given the field position.
A gutsy call here, fourth and inches. Navy operating from its own 10-yard line. Averaging 286.7 yards per game on the ground. Number one in the country, Minnesota number two. And they'll take a timeout. Owens came to the line and indicated that his team is going to talk about it. We'll step aside. First quarter action.
The inspirational true story.
I have to believe I got some kind of say over our lives.
Daddy.
Of a man who was given a second chance.
This time around, I know what I'm fighting for.
To show the world.
You can do it, Jay!
The champion inside.
Pop, pop, bang!
Hailed by critics and audiences alike. As Ron Howard's best movie.
People saying you're their inspiration.
Russell Crowe, Renee Zellweger.
This is your night.
Cinderella Man on DVD Tuesday. Imagine simultaneously tracking over 100 enemy targets on land, sea, and in the air from thousands of miles away. It's the most powerful weapon system ever invented. It's called Aegis, and it's just one of the amazing technologies you'll find only in the United States Navy. Navy, accelerate your life. Log on to the Life Accelerator at Navy.com.
I'm just like you. I work hard every day. Back pain or not, because I get big relief from the Icy Hot Back Patch.
Bigger than many ordinary patches, first it's icy to dull the pain, then hot to relax it away. The Icy Hot Back Patch.
Count on it.
If you haven't tried Coors in a while, you may have forgotten how cold and refreshing a Rocky Mountain beer can taste. So crack one open and refresh your memory.
Rocky Mountain High, Colorado.
Officially, the unit does not exist. And we answer only to one man.
I need some explanation.
Ask for the president. Welcome to the unit.
Yeah, right now, Navy's focus is to submarine themselves into a six-inch gain. It is fourth and inches. Navy has used a timeout, and the ball is in between their own 10 and 11-yard line.
And you got to remember, Navy has the best rushing offense in football, but this is a dangerous play in my eyes because, you know, Army does not have a great offense. So it looks like they're going to run the punt team on, which would be the right thing to do. Then they're running the punt team off, and they're actually trying to play games with Army right here.
And a flag comes down. Owens pointing in the direction of Army. Why wouldn't he? Ron Cherry is our referee.
Having a legal substitution against Navy breaking the huddle with more than 11 players. We got to go 5 yards and step fourth down.
Well, I think the decision was just made for them, Boomer.
Well, it was, and now you're taking it back 5 yards, and you're making it even more difficult for the punter. So I've never really seen that before.
Scott Westin.
They did all of that for a 5-yard penalty. Eric Shuey, the punter, averaging just under 39 yards per boot. Scott Wesley, dangerous return man. standing at his own 45. He will move forward and catch at the 40. Ooh, upended. Able to hold on to the football at the 41-yard line. Navy able to get down the field with Reggie Campbell, the little sophomore, 5'6", to make the play on special teams. But Army's going to have excellent field position at the 41. Wesley took the shot, but held on to the big hit.
No, I'm just online paying the credit card bill.
What?
No, I'll be home soon.
We don't want a late fee. Honey, I told you we can't.
I saw this before.
That's the last one, man. Let's go.
Sometimes you can't help paying late. Avoid late fees with the new Citi Simplicity card. No late fees when you make a purchase each billing period. Citi, live richly.
Virtually inaccessible, the remote Northern Territory is a fortress of alpine peaks. The terrain so brutal, its beauty has seldom been seen by human eyes.
Only the most adventurous have ever set foot in this desolate yet picturesque landscape.
This is much better than the movie.
The all-new 7-passenger Jeep Commander. It's your world. Take command.
It's our Miles of Freedom plan. Now get 2 years of gas and scheduled maintenance and a 5-year or 60,000-mile limited warranty on Jeep Commander.
They arrived this morning.
On your ThinkPads.
Yeah, a wireless workhorse. It's got Intel, stainless hinges, titanium composite, hard drive protection. Rock solid.
Slick. Who gets the first one?
I work up real sweat, you know?
Phil.
Phil.
Glutz-proof wireless.
I'm okay.
Only on a ThinkPad with Intel Centrino mobile technology.
Chiefs trophy on the line today in Philadelphia, the 106th meeting between these two rivals. Navy has won 6 of the last 8 matchups. But Army takes over a 1st and 10 at the Navy 41. They're going to open up with a 3-receiver set. Corey Anderson is the 3rd receiver, sophomore out of Tampa, Florida. On 1st down, handoff. Carlton Jones unable to cut it back. And he picks up 3 yards for the Black Knights. Jeremy Chase made the stop. Bowl season is almost here. CBS Sportsline is your destination for complete coverage. Get the latest bowl predictions, plus Dennis Dodd's expert analysis only at CBSSportsline.com. Well, Army's offense has been much improved over the 4-game winning streak. Army is scoring at nearly a 30-point per game clip after averaging 13 points per game their first 6. On the handoff, it's Jones. And look at all the white jerseys swarming. Jeremy McGowan leading that charge along with David Mahoney. We had a chance to sit down with Carlton Jones, the senior, and he told us, look, when I came to Army, I never thought that I could possibly be the guy to lead this team in rushing for 4 consecutive years. I was just hoping to play.
Well, I think he got here at the right place at the right time. I mean, certainly Army was depleted when he got here. He got the opportunity. He seized the moment. And even he told us that when Bobby Ross came here, everything changed.
The way they practice, the way they eat, the way they prepare. 2nd year under Bobby Ross. Jones is the senior from Henderson, North Carolina. 2nd all-time leading rusher behind Mike Mayweather in Army history. Dahman to throw. Able to hit Walter Hill. Fighting for 1st down yardage. He picked up 7. And Jeremy McGowan makes the stop along with Jake Biles.
There was that 3-step drop again that we've been talking about. Letting Zach Dahman step back and get rid of the ball on time, which he's done so well here the last half of the season. And you know, just to go back to Bobby Ross and Paul Johnson, both of us told us that when they came to these academies, the one thing that they had to do is to teach these kids how to practice and at what intensity level they had to practice at. And you would think that because they're academy kids that they would understand that, but they didn't, and now certainly they have really started to understand those prospects and where those coaches want them to go.
First down run for Jones, Caldwell and Mahoney the stop, loss of one as we head to New York. Check in with Tim Brando.
Ion and Boomer, I believe we can punch a ticket to Pasadena for Vince Young. Three touchdown passes, one touchdown run. Here he hits Lima Swede from 31 yards out. That made it 28-3 at that time. It's now 42-3 at the break as he tries to make a move for a national title and maybe even a Heisman Trophy.
Young does throw a beautiful ball, Timmy D, and on display today for the second-ranked Texas Longhorns. Second and 11, handoff. Jones again running into a crowd. This time he'll bang his way for a pickup of three. Keenan Little and Tyler Tidwell once again combining to bring down Carlton Jones. Now for this Navy defense, a lot of question marks when we're coming into the season. They lost a lot of senior leadership, but they've improved as the year has gone on.
And every Navy defender we talk to loves this guy, Buddy Green, their defensive coordinator. And he basically told me yesterday that we play with passion, we play with fire, and that's exactly what you see from a lot of guys that have inexperience. And it's one of the reasons that they've actually, I think, are better than they thought they were going to be.
Third and eight now for Army. Fake the handoff. Protection is there. Dahman to the sideline. First down. Corey Anderson. The sophomore able to work free against Keenan Little. And this drive will continue for Army. .246 to go in this first quarter. Very close to a first down.
And this is a completely different Zach Dahman than we saw last year. And especially when we were talking to him, too, because, you know, his nickname when he was a kid was Opius, Opie Taylor, Mayberry RFD. And when you meet him, you can understand why. He's a baby face, but so much more confident, I thought, this year. Yep. When we talked to him. And I think he is really playing into Kevin Ross's offense now. And Kevin's managing him and making him throw those short passes. As speaking of short, just short right there. And this is the place where you would go for it if you're Army.
Well, they're looking at a 37-yard field goal attempt or a fourth and inches.
Yeah, this is the part of the field where you go for it right here. And I think Bobby Ross would go for it anyway, just to make a statement to his players that, you know, this game means something to him and he wants to get the most out of them. And listen, I played for this guy for 2 years at Maryland. I know how he acts and how he tries to get, you know, the most out of his players. And this is a situation that would do just that.
They're going to go with a jumbo formation. Three tight ends, Ulikowski, Dunn, and Larson. Vitti in front of Wesley. Motion man Larson. They need a couple of inches. Dahman diving forward. And a first down for the Black Knights. So the decision pays off. They needed inches. They got 2 yards.
Boy, I used to hate this play. You don't know what goes on in the bottom of that pile right there. A lot of guys trying to pull the ball out of your hands, and just going right over the top, and it's all about leverage, and that's exactly what Zach Dahman did. Laid on the back of his offensive lineman.
Well, Dahman has looked like a senior so far in this first quarter. And a first and 10 inside the Navy 20. Army looking to strike first. Handoff. That play was whistled dead. Did he get that playoff in time?
Might be the left tackle move before the snap of the ball, Ian. So Bobby Ross does not like these types of mistakes.
False start. Number 75 on the offense. That's a 5-yard penalty. We replayed it there.
Yep. It was the left tackle, Ray Zelenak, sophomore from Fostoria, Ohio. Didn't play as a freshman, but they liked his grit, blue-collar guy.
And we were talking to a bunch of the Army people here, and they were telling me that Stan Brock, the offensive line coach, the former lineman for the San Diego Chargers, has done really a great job with this offensive line, and it has shown as the season has gone on, because they are really the strong point of this team right now.
Brock, a 16-year NFL veteran, turning it upfield. Carlton Jones able to pick up a yard. McGown with the smack on defense. He's the junior out of Houston, Texas. He's played four positions in his 3 years so far at Navy.
And remember, we were talking about how Navy really wanted to focus in on number 30, and that's exactly what McGowan did right there. Just stayed home and did not overreact, and then just filled the hole when he saw the opportunity present itself, and that's exactly how you make the tackle.
Carlton Jones inching closer to back-to-back 1,000-yard rushing seasons. Jones came in 56 yards away from 1,000. Handoff, draw play. It's Jones. Good move by Jones as he gets it inside the 15. Block from the right tackle, Jonathan Conan, helps spring him loose for a 7-yard pickup.
Well, just a little draw play right up the middle. Try to invite the pass. There's a little hole there, I think, on the left by Jared Ulikowski, the tight end. Watch him come down and grab hold right there. Probably should have been a penalty called right there, Ian. Did you see that?
Mm-hmm. I did, but apparently the officials did not.
Obviously.
Under a minute to go now in this first quarter. On third down for Army, a 3rd and 7. Dahman straight back. Protection is there. Dahman throws. Incomplete. Walter Hill had a chance at it.
All right, what am I going to tell you now?
You're going to tell me that the wide receiver should have hauled it in.
You got to have some help right here, and the offensive line's doing their job. They're giving Zach Dahman plenty of time, and watch, he'll come right across the middle. He's wide open. Now, you'd like a little bit better throw, but certainly should be catchable by a wide receiver right here.
So the diving attempt by the junior from Randallstown, Maryland, Justin Koenig, a 32-yard field goal attempt. He's got it. The last time Army had a lead in this series was at the end of the 2001 matchup. Army with a 3-0 advantage over Navy, first quarter.
With the rich, bold flavor, Dr. Pepper. One taste, and you get it.
Hello, I'm home.
Hey, honey, have you seen the credit card bill?
I may have thrown it away.
My disco pants.
Why?
Where is it? I'm not paying the late fee.
Sometimes you can't help paying late. Avoid late fees with the new Citi Simplicity card. No late fees when you make a purchase each billing period. Citi, live richly.
How are things at the office?
The same as usual. Welcome to the unit.
Next Saturday, we've got two scoops of hoop. Top-ranked Duke takes on the second-ranked Longhorns of Texas. Then the Kentucky Wildcats tangle with Indiana for Oklahoma and Gonzaga. Check your local listings. Reggie Campbell on the return for Navy. And Campbell gets hit from behind after running into some resistance. He's got a 14-yard return, and Jordan Murray makes the play on special teams for Army. 11 plays, just 26 yards. They took over with excellent field position, but 32-yard field goal for Koenig gives Army the 3-0 lead.
But you see that time of possession, which is so important when you're playing against a team like Navy. As Paul Johnson was telling us, when his team runs the ball effectively, you know, their defense thinks, wow, we had such a great game. But no, it's because our offense has controlled the football. So far, I think that's exactly what Army has done this first quarter.
He didn't really want to burst their bubble. He'll let them think they had a great game, but they only had to be on the field for 8 plays. Lamar Owens will keep it himself. 4-yard gain. And just about everybody was involved defensively for Army. That's going to do it for this first quarter. Army with a 3-0 lead over Navy. The 106th meeting between these two schools. You're watching the Home Depot College Football on CBS, America's number one network.
In a time of hunger, empires fall, heroes rise, and chicken rules. Cows in shining armor, the 2006 Chick-fil-A calendar. Meet Charbroilermane, Reuben Hood, Boldhoof, and more. Just $5 and filled with coupons for delicious food. 'Tis nobler to eat more chicken at Chick-fil-A.
Some movies live in your heart for so long.
That is so beautiful.
You're still crying when the sequel comes out.
All better.
Look who's back.
Gizmo. Goose Call.
Boom, baby. In the sequel to The Emperor's New Groove.
Well, at least you're not a cat anymore. Except for that.
The original voice cast returns.
I'm nice now. Didn't you see the first movie?
Kronk's New Groove, rated G.
Me, I knew that.
All new on Disney DVD December 13th. Makes a groovy gift.
This is CBS, America's most watched network.
Shop Scioto Valley's holiday celebration
for family fun and relaxation.
Get huge savings on Hot Springs, Viking, and Cal Spas.
Choose from five models priced as low as $18.88.
But no more than $29.99.
Tanning systems start at just $9.99.
Stay warm and cozy this winter with a vent-free gas fireplace for just $4.88. Or electric fireplace from $1.99.
Gas logs start at just $99.
Only at Scioto Valley.
We have all the fun.
For the car, truck, or SUV lover in your life, there's just one place to shop this holiday season.
Jegs.
Jegs Creeper Seat Combo makes a perfect holiday gift. Purchase right now and save $15. Jegs 1.5-ton floor jack is lightweight, and you save $30 only at Jegs. For the kid in all of us, Jegs die-cast collectible racers, starting at under $10. And this season, Jegs gift certificates make the perfect holiday gift. For the best holiday gifts and thousands of new low prices, get into
Jegs.
The quickest NHL goal ever scored was in just 5 seconds. Like Speed Read, the fastest way to read the news each day on page 2 of the Dispatch. Think you don't have time to read the paper? Think again. Speed Read, every day in the Columbus Dispatch. A new way to read the news.
Forgive a little bit. I give a little bit of my life for you.
I'm craving for that lady.
Since you've been gone.
Mix 97.1, 80s, 90s, now.
Skate on State December 3rd and help out the 10 TV Family Fund.
The second quarter in Philadelphia, Iron Eagle, Boomer Esiason, Dwayne Ballon, and the rest of our CBS crew. 3-0. Bobby Ross's Army Black Knights in front of Navy. At a 2nd and 6 upcoming for Paul Johnson's team. Lamar Owens, he's the senior. He was part of that first recruiting class for Paul Johnson when he took over here at the Naval Academy. Owens has 3 100-yard rushing games this season. And the pitch, cutting it upfield, Marco Nelson able to break free for a 10-yard gain. Rob Davis cut him down low to make the stop. You're more on Owens. He actually wasn't committed to play here at Navy coming out of high school initially.
No, he was going to go to Georgia Southern, and that's where Paul Johnson was prior to coming to Navy. And, you know, we were talking to Owens yesterday. Was it easy for you to sit out and wait? And, you know, he said it was easy because our team was winning, and I wanted to do whatever it was for the team, and that's so refreshing to hear in this day and age.
And Owens. Sneaky play by Owens to keep it himself. And a 10-yard gain, Brandon Thompson making the stop. Just underway here in the second quarter. And Navy now is on the move with a first down. 1st and 10 from the midshipman 46-yard line. A Justin Koenig field goal for Army is the difference right now. Navy running that triple option scheme. Toss, Campbell, big gain. Reggie Campbell takes it the distance. Touchdown, Navy.
And what a Another great play by Lamar Owens as he does a whirl spin in the backfield. And then we were talking about, it's all about the decisions that the quarterback makes in the spread option. And right here, Lamar Owens reads it perfectly as he takes the tackle and flips the ball to Reggie Campbell, who goes down the sideline. And remember, the slot backs are called A-backs. And what did Reggie Campbell tell us? A's make plays. And that's exactly what Reggie did right there.
Campbell is 5'6", 164 pounds, one of the smallest Division I football players in the country, as Joey Bullen tacks on the extra point. 54-yard burst for the slot back Reggie Campbell out of Sanford, Florida. He gives Navy a 7-3 lead early second quarter. We'll come back. Army-Navy football on CBS.
Why am I in the Army Reserve? It's not just for the experience or the training I can use as a soldier and as a civilian. It's for them, for my country, and it's all worth fighting for.
Visit GoArmyReserve.com.
Wow, that's beautiful.
Hey, look at that one.
Whoa.
I like that one. That was cool.
The all-new 7-passenger Jeep Commander with available Command View skylights. It's your world. Take command.
It's our Miles of Freedom plan. Now get 2 years of gas and scheduled maintenance and a 5-year or 60,000-mile limited warranty on Jeep Commander.
When I was your age, we didn't have on-demand.
So what'd you do?
We watched whatever shows were on.
What about movies?
We had these places called video rental stores. You travel miles to get there. And sometimes you'd get there and the movie you wanted was already rented out.
You live quite a life.
Free movies, shows, and more. Ready to watch when you are with On Demand from Comcast Digital Cable. It's Comcasting.
The Unit, coming to CBS.
Time right now for the Hartford playbook.
Two great plays right here, Ian. One right here by the fullback. Ballard, number 22. He's going to take on number 22, Pell, over here on defense. He's going to make the key block. Lamar Owens is going to absorb the tackle. He makes the decision. And there is nobody out there. That, remember, we talked about assignment football for the Army defense. Well, Luke Pell was taken out of his assignment by a great block by Adam Ballard.
Well, Reggie Campbell, who runs track for Navy. I'm not sure you could tell on that play.
You know, I kind of think like he's your favorite player for some reason. Maybe because you and he are about the same size.
Yeah, I was willing to go back to back. I don't think he was willing.
He didn't find it funny.
No, he didn't find it the least bit comical, did he?
Well, you know, he plays the position of slot back. And remember, the slot back in this offense is known as the A-back. And as he told us yesterday, he said A's make plays. And I have to tell you, Lamar Owens made a great play absorbing the tackle. And then, of course, Adam Ballard made the great block on Luke Pell to spring Reggie Campbell for that 54-yard touchdown run.
Well, you saw the explosive speed from Campbell. Joey Bullen will kick it off. Scott Wesley, the deep man for Army. And now the Black Knights trail 7-3. Wesley will take it out. Able to break a couple of tackles, then finally swarmed along the sideline after the 22-yard return. Zerbin Singleton downfield to make the play.
Take a look at Owens here as he absorbs the tackle. This is what you have to do in the option. He reads it, he takes the tackle, the ball's out of his hands, and he's probably listening right now to the brigade of midshipmen who are behind him cheering as Reggie Campbell was running down the sideline.
So Navy with a 7-3 lead, 13:51 to go, first half. Army ball, a first and 10 at its own 21-yard line. Zach Dahman, 5 of 8 so far, handoff to Jones. He's got some room to work with. And Jones picks up eight. We go downstairs. Here's Dwayne Bowen.
Hi, and I'm with Veterans Affairs Secretary Jim Nicholson. Mr. Secretary, thank you for joining us. Can you put into words what this game means to the military personnel around the world?
Again, it's a great patriotic gathering for all the armed forces throughout the world, our 25 million veterans, and really for all the people in America. This is a wonderful occasion of coming together of the cream of the crop of these two great academies, and America joins hands in a game like this.
Thank you, Mr. Secretary. Ian?
All right, Dwayne. Mr. Secretary with a snazzy tie as well. Here's Dahmen. Little floater for Jones. And a little juke move out across the 30-yard line. Tyler Tidwell with another tackle for the Naval Academy.
I don't know if he made the first down. This looks like it's going to be third and short right here, Ian. And again, another safe play for Zach Dahmen to complete a pass. And we go back to who this kid was before this year. And I think he was a little bit scattershot. He was kind of not comfortable in this offense last year. They kind of pared it down a little bit and they played to his strengths. And so far he's having a very good football game.
Completion percentage this year is up 55%. Six completions to six different receivers so far today for Dahmen. Handoff, and it's Jones. And it will be enough for the first down.
You know, he had two big third down throws already in this game that were dropped by his receivers. And, you know, he's last year, I just felt like talking to him, he was quiet.
Yep.
I thought of a sensitive kind of guy, and you know, most quarterbacks are sensitive, but he may be too sensitive. But this year, definitely more confident, more in charge of this offense.
He's got 20 Army passing records, but those numbers are deceiving. They were so bad his first 3 years that Army found themselves throwing the football, just trying to get back into games after falling behind. Take the handoff. Dahmen will throw on an out route. Jeremy Trimble. And a clean catch for Trimble. And coming soon to CBS, a military unit so top secret, even their wives can't know it exists. Undercover missions and dark secrets are at stake on The Unit. Coming soon to CBS, America's number one network. We'll call it a second and four after a gain of six through the air. Jones, the lone setback. Dahmen working with center Pete Beard. He's the senior out of Jamesville, Wisconsin. The give is to Jones, up the middle. And a first down for Army. 7 yard gain for Jones. Good block from the left guard, Dan Evans. Smash mouth football. That's the way Army's trying to play this one.
Stay the course. Run when you can. Don't get down and don't get worried if you do get down. And see Carlton Jones, a nice little nifty move right there at the line of scrimmage. But you know, Bobby Ross told us, listen, you know, we're not going to just abandon the running game if we get behind in this game. And you know, it's a close game, but they're going to really try to pound it at you and try to control the football and keep that Navy offense off the field.
And Jones is a workhorse. They'll give it to him 20 plus times a game. This is Jones turning the corner and forced out of bounds. Good block by the fullback Vitti, and a 20-yard rip by Carlton Jones.
And Iron, you are right. Watch Vitti, the fullback, lead Jones around the corner. You also have this often. There's a little hold right there again by Ulikowski. That's twice that he's gotten away with a few holds. But right there, Vitti makes the block in the hole, and then Jones takes it to the sideline.
Carlton Jones now at 999 rushing yards on the season. Scott Wesley comes in to give Jones a breather. Army in Navy territory. On the give, driving forward, Wesley. Tyler Tidwell again involved defensively for Navy, then getting some help from the rest of his defensive teammates. How about Scott Wesley? He's a senior out of Pine Bluff, Arkansas. Wesley, a walk-on for this Army football program. He said Carlton Jones and he were always good friends, but when he made the switch from wide receiver, their relationship grew even stronger. And now a deeper bond between the two running backs. Quick toss. Jacob Murphy creating after the catch. And Murphy dragging Jeremy McGowan on his back. as he gets it inside the 25. That's a 13-yard hookup.
And you were talking about Wesley. You know, he was their short yardage back, and Bobby Ross told us that, you know, every time he took a hit, he kind of broke the tackle. Nobody could bring him down with their first hit. We saw that on the kickoff return on this drive, but he's a guy that you have to get on the football field. So why not put him at the tailback position, because those are the guys that are going to touch the ball the most in this offense.
Well, Jones is back in there. And Army now with a first and 10 at the 22 of the midshipman. Navy with a 7-3 lead. Handoff. Jones cuts. And the pursuit from Navy. Jeremy Chase helps slow him down. And a loss of 2 on the play.
Well, this is all about the Navy defensive line just pushing back and displacing the offensive line of the Corps of Cadets. As you can see, Chase coming back and making a nice tackle. So, you know, Chase was a pretty good story as well. You know, none of these guys on defense wanted to let down. They didn't want this to be a rebuilding year. They wanted it to sustain the success that they've had in the previous 2 years. And I think by going to a bowl game for the third year in a row, they've sustained. They really have.
Buddy Green, defensive coordinator, told us the other day, he's so proud of this defense and the improvement they've shown from week to week. It's Jones. And a whistle blew, penalty marker on the play.
There's no play, delay of game. Number 7, offense, the 5-yard penalty.
Well, back it up 5 yards. Didn't get the playoff in time. Looks like he ran out of paint, that young man.
Those are inexcusable penalties, and those are the types of things that drive Bobby Ross, Paul Johnson, all coaches for that matter, crazy.
Well, so instead, they're staring at a 2nd and 17 now from the 29-yard line. Clock is moving, 8:49 and counting, left in the second quarter. At Lincoln Financial Field. 3 receiver set. Domin on the draw play. Can Jones break free? He cannot. Read perfectly by Jake Biles, the senior. Biles, who played for his dad Ray in high school in Lorena, Texas.
And this is just Biles making a play, fighting off the stiff arm.
And a loss of 1 on the play. Biles, who was second string last year. When we asked him about the pressure of moving forward, becoming a starter, he said, hey, I prepared like I was a starter last year. I felt I was fully prepared to take over more responsibility. Now a 3rd and 18 for Army. Back to throw. Domin has time. Loops it. Man open. Touchdown. Jeremy Trimble. Touchdown, Army.
Boy, that ball hung up there a while, didn't it? It seemed like a punt.
Trimble is a patient young man, waiting for it. Keenan Little tried to close in on Trimble to make the play.
I'm just trying to wonder, Army, where was Keenan Little when the ball was in the air?
Black Knights regain the lead. Koenig on for the extra point. A 30-yard touchdown. Domin to Trimble. 10-7. Army in front. CBS Sports coverage of the Home Depot College Football on CBS will continue after this message and a word from your local station.
This is CBS, America's most watched network.
Make this a December he'll truly remember at the December to Remember sales event, where you'll find the best values of the year on your favorite Lexus vehicles. See your Lexus dealer.
It isn't about technology, and it isn't about us. At Doppler 10 Weather, our forecast is about you. Will your drive to work be trouble-free? Will your child's school open on time? When you tune in to 10TV, you'll get answers to those questions in a reliable, no-nonsense forecast. It's the winter weather forecast you ask for, delivered by people you trust. Doppler 10 Weather, only on Central Ohio's News Leader.
Got a sports question, comment, or a gripe? Send it in to Wall-to-Wall Sports Big Question of the Week.
Brought to you by Chipotle Mexican Grill, gourmet burritos and tacos.
The law calls for every driver to have car insurance, but weather like this demands it.
Call 888-888-DISPATCH Classifieds. There's pets for sale, find a new roommate, just dial 8s and sell today. Call 888-888-DISPATCH Classifieds. Call 888-888-DISPATCH Classifieds today. Sell the car to gnomes that guard the gate. It's the perfect way to make some space. Call 888-888-DISPATCH Classifieds today. Call 888-888-888. Call today.
You're watching 10TV, Central Ohio's news leader.
With the help of Home Depot, let's take a look at the tools for success.
Well, for Army, it all starts with Carlton Jones, and here he is running wide to the left for a big 20-yard gain. Then it's the three-step dropping pass, quick passing game, and then, of course, third and 18. Who would have thought that Army could come up with this play, but it's Trimble in for the touchdown, and it's a new Zach Dahmen who's having a whale of a football game, and that time Trimble holds on to the ball. And more importantly, take a look at this drive, Ian. 6 minutes and 7 seconds controlling the football. It just gives you such a better chance to win. It keeps Navy's offense off the field. And you know, Bobby Ross and this new attitude Army is self-evident. It's evident right here. We see it before us, boy. Take a look at this.
Well, there's no silence of the Lambs so far. Now, Paul Johnson, this is not a position that he's accustomed to being in as the head coach of Navy.
Against Army. Right, yeah.
You know, it's funny because they talked a big game the last couple of years, Army did. We're ready for this matchup. But you never quite believed it when you left West Point. This year, I think you and I had a different feeling leaving our meetings with the Cadets. Koenig to kick off to Reggie Campbell. Campbell breaks one tackle and driven backwards. It'll be whistled dead at the 17-yard line, but John Plumstead, a freshman linebacker from Honor, Michigan, with a spirited play on special teams. 10-7, Army leads it.
Can I help you find something?
Yeah, I'm looking for a gift for my father-in-law.
Hey, what about a gift card?
Yeah, that'll work.
Good thinking.
A Home Depot gift card is the whole store in a festive little envelope. Now in bright new holiday designs. It's always the right size. Make it holiday at the Home Depot.
The Home Depot. You can do it, we can help.
People who visit Geico.com could save hundreds on car insurance, yeah? Big news, yeah? But not if no one hears it, which is why I need you to help spread the word. Otherwise, our big news is nothing but a stray little fact. A wee orphan of truth wandering the streets looking for a home in someone's ear. Oh, that was easy.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
So what'd they say?
3 hours.
We'll still be at my folks for Christmas.
I say we start Christmas right now.
A gift from Kay Jewelers means every diamond is hand-selected to match beautifully. And she'll absolutely love it.
At least Santa's still flying.
Every kiss begins with Kay.
Create your own holiday feast at Red Lobster. Combine two or three of your seafood favorites from 10 signature dishes, including our tender snow crab. Turn a meal into a celebration this holiday at Red Lobster.
Up to the minute sports news, real-time scores, outspoken writers, exclusive video, and award-winning fantasy sports. Go to CBSSportsLine.com.
A flashback, the last Army victory in this series, 2001 sellout crowd. Ardells Daniels scores on a 60-yard run. Amari Thompson returns the second half kickoff, 96 yards. Army, a 26-17 victory for Todd Berry. The last time the Black Knights knocked off the Midshipmen. Right now, Army with a 10-7 advantage. 7:45 mark, second quarter. Navy has the ball, a first and 10 at its own 17-yard line to open up this series. Reggie Campbell in there along with Marco Nelson. Campbell, the motion man, he'll get the toss. Cannot get to the corner. Caleb Campbell was able to read that one perfectly. Coming soon to CBS, the secret missions and secret lives of a covert team of special forces engaged in undercover missions around the world. The Unit, coming soon to CBS, America's number one network. A 1 yard gain for Campbell and a second and 9. Hand off, it's a toss. Nelson, and able to cut to the perimeter.
All right, he got you on that one, and that's exactly what happens in this option. You got your eyes in the backfield. You got to read your keys, Ian. I keep telling you, you got to read your keys on the spread option.
I need to make an algorithm of what's happening on offense, as you well know, Boomer.
Well, I'll take a look at this. Puts it in the belly of Ballard. Does a great job, Lamar Owens does. He absorbs the tackle again. And again, it's assignment football for Army. The man who is assigned for the running back went back to tackle Lamar Owens. So a mistake on the defense for Army.
Deion Tarver, a cornerback. We'll tell you that story in a moment. This is Owens, able to move forward for a first down and a 7 yard gain. Deion Tarver is the senior out of San Antonio, Texas. And when we sat down with the Army Black Knights, you asked Deion Tarver, how do you defend this triple option? What did he tell us?
He said, well, we have to build an algorithm. And you and I both looked at each other and said, what? I had never heard that in a football meeting ever. So that was a first.
He said it with a straight face. He meant it.
Obviously.
On first down for Navy. The toss. Nelson! Look at the real estate in front of him. Cameron Craig, the defensive end, able to chase him down, but a 28-yard gain for the senior from Scottsdale, Arizona, Marco Nelson.
And I was telling you at the beginning of the game, if Owens is on, they are so dangerous, and he is on thus far. These last two series, he has absolutely been perfect, knowing when to run with it, making crucial first downs, and knowing when to pitch it. And right here, he makes a wonderful pitch. Doesn't seem like much, but that's what this offense is predicated on, that quarterback making that quick decision as to whether or not to keep it or to pitch it.
And the big play ability of Nelson puts the ball at the 39 of Army. On the throw, first one of the day to Jason Tomlinson. And Tomlinson picks up 4 yards through the air. Let's head to New York. Check in with Tim Brando.
All right, fellas. Vince Young is taking a break after throwing 3 touchdown passes, running for another one. Henry Melton takes it in from a yard out. They've hung 70 on Colorado with still plenty of time in the third. Archie Manning was right last week when he said the Big 12 North should have assembled an all-star team to play Texas.
Archie was right on, wasn't he?
He sure was. I don't think Colorado wanted any part of that Big 12 championship. It's Owens. And a spin move for Owens as he makes his way to the 30-yard line. It's going to be a little bit short of a first down. Needed 6. He got 5. A 3rd and 1 upcoming as Barrett Scruggs was able to make the play for Army.
And what we're seeing here is a contrast of offenses and quarterback responsibilities. On one side, Zach Tomlin throwing a touchdown pass has been very good throwing the ball on third down. And on the other side, it's Lamar Owens making all the right decisions in the spread option offense.
18 rushes, just 1 pass so far. Make it 19 running plays as Owens gets the first down himself.
Remember, we talked to John Mumford. He's the defensive coordinator for the Army Corps of Cadets, and he was telling us it's a net. We got to keep Navy in a net. We just got to try to keep them from making those big plays. So thus far, that has not been the way this Army defense has played, especially after the touchdown run from Campbell.
Navy midshipmen going to their 12th bowl game, 3rd in a row. The inaugural Poinsettia Bowl will be played December 22nd in San Diego against Colorado State. Here's Owens. Breaks free. Owen runs down the sideline. How did he do it? Touchdown, Navy. Caleb Campbell was unable to wrap him up. And the midshipmen have answered.
And it is punch, counterpunch from each of these quarterbacks answering the previous score. And this time, Lamar Owens again makes the right decision, keeps the ball, and then not only does he make the right decision, he makes a fantastic play to get away from Campbell.
Extra point from Joey Bullen. And Hampton was able to place it down. Owens, seventh rushing touchdown in his last four games, and what an individual effort this was from the senior out of Benedictine Military in Savannah, Georgia. Owens puts Navy back in front.
Nice shot.
Thanks. I'm up 14 to 12. Your ball.
Jeep Liberty. The world is your playground. It's our Miles of Freedom plan. Now get 2 years of gas and scheduled maintenance and a 5-year or 60,000-mile limited warranty on Jeep Liberty.
And I don't even have that insurance.
What insurance, Santa?
The one that pays you cash if you're hurt and can't work.
Aflac, ask about it at work.
Can you just send down the toys?
Something smells good. Delivery?
It's not delivery, it's DiGiorno.
DiGiorno? You fix the oven?
Introducing DiGiorno Microwave Pizza. Rises up in minutes for oven-baked taste in a hurry. It's not delivery, it's DiGiorno Microwave.
New on Disney DVD at Sky High. Every student has exceptional powers.
He's strong.
But they're not always
a guinea pig
what you'd expect.
I built
great.
Sky High.
I'll get the nerves.
Own it today on Disney DVD.
Tim Brando in New York coming up with the Geico Halftime Report. Spencer and I will get you caught up on all of today's action, including Tulsa answers the trivia question, which school won the first ever conference USA title game? They beat Central Florida 44-27 as Terry and Adams takes it in. Now back to Army Navy.
Second quarter, 3:46 remaining, and Navy now has a 14-10 lead on Army. Lamar Owens, I want to talk about making a play. 28-yard touchdown run.
And both quarterbacks are having a whale of a football game. Now, we talked about the contrast between the two of them. Dahman, 9 completions, 90 yards, and 1 touchdown pass, 1 carry for 3 yards. And Owens, 9 rushes for 71 yards and 1 touchdown, and 1 completion for 4 yards. So both senior quarterbacks playing extremely well in the first half.
Joey Bullen will kick off for Navy. Scott Wesley standing at his own 4-yard line for Army. Low kick. On the ground, taken by Goldsby. And Goldsby, one of the up men there as he crosses the 30, 15-yard return. Back downstairs, Dwayne Ballin.
Hi, and thank you. I am with Dr. Buzz Aldrin, the second man to set foot on the moon and a West Point graduate. You were chatting with me earlier, Dr. Aldrin,
yes,
about your memories of this game. When you came to West Point, Blanchard and Davis had just left. Great Army.
That's right. I saw them play their last game in the fall of 1946. Then I came in, entered West Point in July of 47, graduated in 51 into the Air Force.
You must like the scoreboard right now as the Black Knights are on the move.
Well, I hope they're moving a little faster. They got a little catching up to do right now.
Thank you. Dr. Buzz Aldrin, second man to set foot on the moon, gentlemen.
Thanks very much. There's the new book, Reaching for the Moon, and it's like a who's who. You read the alumni list of both of these academies. Buzz Aldrin graduated third in his class at West Point in 1951. Became the second man to set foot on the moon when he was part of the Apollo 11 mission. The first man lunar landing. And nice enough to join us here this afternoon in Philadelphia. Jones has gone over 1,000 yards for the season. And tries to fall forward for a 3-yard gain. He's going to come up a little bit shy of a first down for Army.
And that's his 16th carry of the game. So this is the game plan that Kevin Ross told us that he was going to employ. It's going to be a lot of Carlton Jones, a lot of quick 3-step drops, 5-step drops for Zach Domin. And really, I think so far the Army offense has run their game plan almost to perfection.
Now a pivotal 3rd and 2. As Army tries to get some points on the board before halftime. Jones and Vitti in the backfield. This will be Jones getting the call, and he doesn't get there. Needed 2, got 1. First man there was Biles, the inside linebacker. Biles will be part of the Marine Corps ground team when he graduates.
And we should also remind folks that this senior class, so you know, for both teams, are the first group of young men to go to our military academies post 9/11, knowing what our country is dealing with. So I think their call to service makes that even more impressive.
They are going for it on 4th and 1 with 1:36 to go, first half.
I think they're going for it. I don't think they are.
They're trying to draw Navy off sides.
That's what I think they're doing.
Won't happen.
Cross the snap. Play of game.
Play clock had hit 0. Unless somebody had called a timeout.
I think Army might have called a timeout.
Play of game.
Nope, I guess not.
Offense number 7. It's a 5-yard penalty.
You know, it was kind of interesting. The referee started to call the penalty, and the players were still, you know, locked in on the football.
Probably should have just called the timeout. Why take the delay and take the 5-yard hit?
The only thing they, for me, I would have went for it right there, because Navy's offense has really been moving the ball exceptionally well the last 2 times out, and I think that you've got to take the ball out of their hands.
Instead, it's Owen Tolson with Tomlinson, the return man, takes a roll and will settle in at the 34-yard line of Navy. Coming up, Geico halftime report. Tim Brando and Spencer Tillman will get you caught up with all the scores and highlights, including Texas trying to secure its Rose Bowl berth. Looks like that's going to happen. And they'll preview the SEC championship game between LSU and Georgia. That'll be the second half of our college football doubleheader here on CBS.
Well, I think Army made a mistake there. I would have went for it. Now, Navy's got great field position here because of a poor punt, but again, remember, the best defense for Army is to keep this Navy running game on the sideline.
And look at Owen, straight back to throw. On time to Reggie Campbell. And they pick up chunks of yards on one play, 21 yards through the air. 10th catch of the season for Campbell. He averages nearly 23 yards per reception.
And I think Bobby Ross was thinking that, well, you know, we're under 2 minutes. There's not a lot of time here, so we'll punt it. We'll play a little field position. But, you know, the way this offense all of a sudden has exploded the last couple series out, look at this, 10.2 yards per play. That's pretty impressive.
And Navy is threatening again. Here's Owens. He's got room. Owen, he's not going to slide down. He's going to take it as far as he can. I don't think he slides by nature. 11-yard gain.
I would say he is a quarterback that is in rhythm right now. And when you're in rhythm and you see the field and you can feel things around you and you can make plays, that's when you're at your best. And 10 rushes, 82 yards, a couple pass completions. Hey, this kid is having a great day today.
Lamar Owens had attempted just 6 career passes before this season, his senior year, sitting behind Candido and Polanco. On the toss, Marco Nelson. And Boomer, that's 3 plays. Boom, boom, boom. 3 in a row. That covers 9 yards.
And that's why I would have went for it on 4th and, you know, less than a yard. You're witnessing the reason why you would go for it in that situation, because this offense has not been stopped.
Clock is moving, 37 seconds left, 2nd and 1. And Ballard trying to push the pile. That's going to be close. Looks like he got a favorable spot. And should be enough for a first down. 31 seconds left.
Well, here's where Navy gets a break now, because the officials are going to measure for this. But maybe they'll call timeout instead. Actually, the officials are going to call timeout and measure. So Navy gets a break here by not having to use one of their timeouts.
Let's see if Ballard got to the spot. Would give them a first and 10 at the 24, and he's got it.
So they need to get the play called, get up to the line of scrimmage, and as soon as the referee sets the ball in play, snap it and go. And that's exactly what they're doing. Good coaching by Paul Johnson and good awareness by Lamar Owens, the quarterback.
Navy still has two timeouts to work with. And a first down for the midshipman. Three receivers set. Here's Owens rolling and throwing on the run. Catch made by Tyree Barnes, the freshman from Hampton, Virginia. And Navy has moved the football with ease during this two-minute drill.
And because it's a first down, the clock stops in college football. And right now, Lamar Owens, all he has to do is down it, and he saves his timeout. And that's exactly what he does.
So the clock ticks down to 18 seconds left.
And what a half for Lamar Owens, who's showing now not only does he make the right decisions running the football, but has really done a good job running the two-minute drill here at the end of the first half.
10 carries, 82 yards for Owens and a touchdown. He is 3 of 4 throwing the ball, and that one incompletion is the spike you just saw.
This is where Army defense has got to step up right here and hold them to at least a field goal attempt.
17 seconds remain. Fake the handoff. There's the pitch. Campbell able to get to the outside. But Caleb Campbell, no relation, hit him around the helmet area. Clock is stopped with 10 seconds left. First half, and Navy in front.
What size is your carbon footprint?
Taking? Size of what?
Haven't the foggiest idea.
I couldn't tell you.
What does that mean?
What?
What?
No idea. What are you meaning?
The faintest idea.
What is that?
I don't know. Really, I don't know.
Sorry, I don't understand what you mean.
What? Do you know yours?
The financial world is filled with difficult decisions. Who inspires confidence? Where can you turn? Ask your financial advisor about the Hartford Mutual Funds, offered by The Hartford, a company built on 194 years of trust. Request a complete prospectus with investment objectives, risks, fees, expenses, and other information to read and consider carefully before investing or sending money.
The Unit, coming to CBS.
10 seconds left in this first half. Navy trying to add to its lead. Boomer, ball is spotted at the Army 2-yard line. Do they have enough time here to work with to get a playoff? And if it doesn't get into the end zone, kick a field goal.
Oh yeah, they do. They also have one timeout left, so there's no problem in terms of timing here. So they can definitely run a play within the line of scrimmage. And with the way that they've been running the play, I don't think a yard is going to be a hard thing to follow here. And it is third and goal. So then they'll elect, let's say they don't make it, do we go for it or do we kick the field goal? So
a couple of decisions here for Paul Johnson. 10 seconds remaining in this second quarter. Joey Bullen waiting for a potential field goal attempt. Played 1 year of sprint football for Navy. Actually recruited to play soccer. Then they found him a spot on the football team as the place kicker.
You find a spot on the football team for anybody that can play football at these academies. As both coaches told us, they're smaller, they're slower, they're more analytical, though.
They sure are. We've learned that. And they play with a lot of heart. Ball is spotted inside the two. Navy trying to cash in. Owens through the lane for the touchdown. Midshipmen add to their lead. And what a first half it has been for the senior Lamar Owens, the Navy co-captain.
11 rushes, 83 yards, and 2 touchdowns, and a very impressive 2-minute drive right there for Navy.
Extra point from the sophomore Bullock. Owens, second rushing touchdown of the day. 8 plays, 66 yards, and Navy did it in a blur.
This could be the best day of my life. I just got my own place. It's a 1-bedroom apartment. I mean, yeah, the kitchen and bathroom are also in the bedroom, but I bought a couch. And oh, this beautiful coffee table, dresser, bureau thing. I use a Discover card so I can earn cash on everything I buy. It's money I use to help me add on to my sweet new den.
Another reason it pays to Discover, the Discover card.
The echo in the gym. The squeak of the shoes. The buzzer. The brick. The whistle. The crowd. Swish. I left the game, but it'll never leave me.
There are over 360,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us are going pro in something other than sports.
Tiger Stadium on Saturday night is by far the loudest in the country. It actually registered as a small earthquake in the geology building.
Florida State University, home of my Seminoles, number one team in the country.
Florida State, 85,000 screaming fans at the Swamp.
Night games in Tallahassee. We got Chief Osceola, we got Renegade the Horse, we got the Flaming Spear.
Back and forth at the end, Florida pulls it out 32-29.
Hot boudin, cold couscous. Come on, Tigers, and poosh, poosh, poosh. Yeah.
Well, we know the mids are quite fit. When they keep scoring, they keep lifting.
You know, I think you go back to with a minute 20 to go, it was fourth and about, what, a half a yard, Ian?
Yep.
And Army elected to punt the football at that particular juncture, and it was 14-10. And you know, decisions are made on the sideline of football games as football games unfold before your eyes, and you see how the game is flowing. And at that point, I felt like the Army defense was getting overrun by the Navy offense. If I were standing on the sideline of Army, I would have went for it simply because of that reason.
And Bullen will skim this one on the ground. Taken by Army. Back to the 35, Chase McCoy, a junior tight end. And only 3 seconds remain in this first half. And you're right, a decision that cost Army. You called it at the time, but now looking back in hindsight, you go for it and you cash in there. You probably, even if you don't score, you can use up the rest of the clock.
Right.
And the worst case scenario, you're going into the locker room 14-10.
And a poor punt helps the situation for Navy, and that's exactly what they got from Army.
Dahman will take a knee. So in a first half that saw Army take the lead on 2 occasions, it is Navy that has the 21-10 advantage at the break. Let's go down to the field. Dwayne Bell.
Ian, thank you. Coach Johnson, your offense led by Lamar Owens that second quarter really started clicking.
Yeah, we got the ball some. It's been a game. They've done a nice job holding on to the ball and converting on third downs. When we've had the ball, we've been able to move it. Hopefully, we can continue to do that in the second half.
And how's your back? We know it's been ailing you.
It's okay. I think that once the game started, the adrenaline starts taking over, and I'm okay.
Thanks, Coach. Ian.
All right, Dwayne, thanks very much. That's the end of the first half. Navy with a 21-10 lead on Army. Let's send you to New York and Tim Brenda.
Thank you, Ian. Coming up on the Geico Halftime Report, Spencer and I will have all of today's scores and highlights, including everything's coming up Roses for Texas after this word from your local station.
It's a comfortable feeling knowing your annuity from Prudential can bring you a check every month for the life of your retirement. Prudential Financial, growing and protecting your wealth for retirement.
Taco Bell's new Chipotle Grilled Stuffed Burrito. Loaded with carne asada steak, chipotle seasoned rice, spicy Southwest chipotle sauce, and 3 melted cheeses. All wrapped up and grilled to go. For the perfect balance of flavor and spice, think outside the bun.
I want another championship so bad, it hurts. But
I worked through it with the icy hot sleeve.
Joint hugging pain medicine that starts icy to dull the pain, then gets hot to relax it away.
Get the icy hot sleeve. Hard work and pain relief.
This is CBS, America's most watched network.
Bubba Dub Dub will cover your tub at a price you won't mind a bit. Call Bath Fitter, we're the perfect fit.
People all over your area have discovered the quality and savings with Bath Fitter. Sandra and Jerome Savage said Bath Fitter was about half the cost, and they were able to do two baths for the price of one.
Call Bath Fitter. We're the perfect fit.
Every day, we protect thousands of trees and flowers, wild creatures in the air and on the ground. And every day, we welcome thousands of Central Ohioans to walk, run, or just wander, to discover nature up close, just minutes from home. We're your Metro Parks. For 60 years, preserving Ohio's wild places and open spaces.
Looking to get healthy? Then log on to 10TV.com and...
Once you log on, check out the new Commit to Be Fit link. Health and fitness tools right at your fingertips. A Commit to Be Fit calendar full of community events that will keep the entire family fit. Ready to cook up something good? Check out our healthy recipes. Get in gear with easy exercise tips and all the latest hot topics in health. And it's all just a click away.
Donato's Pizzeria and Metro Parks, proud partners in 10TV's Commit to Be Fit program. The Bengals versus the Steelers, Sunday at 1 on 10TV.
CBS Sports presents the Geico Halftime Report. Geico.com. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Geico Halftime Report. I'm Tim Brando with the score in Philadelphia. Navy leading Army 21-10. Spencer Tillman joins me. I look at Nelson and Owens as the best two athletes on the field for Paul
Johnson.
They're
burning them up big time. You know, look, Navy averages 287 yards a game. They already have 226 right now. Mm-hmm. You got to solve the issue at quarterback there, and Navy's going to run away with this if they don't find an answer quick.
Speaking of running away with it in the Big 12, third and goal for the two. Vince Young's going to scramble. This was made to look easy all day long. You can say, punch your ticket for Pasadena. It's 21-3 at that point.
Talk about a fortress for protection. Take a look at this, folks. Vince Young back there all sorts of time, scanning it, looking it off the zone read. He finds a receiver open there. That was Limus and Swede for the 30-yard touchdown.
And then Michael Griffin blocks the punt. Brandon Foster recovers in the end zone. It's 56-3 at that point. Fellas, listen to this. Texas beat Daniel Baker 92-0 in 1915. They later became a part of Howard Payne University. They were never the same after that. Well, now, Vince Young, look at the numbers. They finally pulled him midway in the third. And, you know, why not the lead?
Well, Mac is going to catch grief for not pulling out. But look, he's at home. This is Vince Young's hometown. The Houston Texans haven't won but one game. Let him have some fun there in Houston.
Well, your hometown, of course, is Tulsa, Oklahoma. And Steve Kragthorpe, in his first year at Conference USA, gets a little help on special
teams. Big return, Joe Burnett, burning him up here, 69 yards. The go-ahead touchdown. UCF taking the lead on this big-time special teams play, 24-21, Tim.
And obviously the comeback, though, for Kragthorpe's team is coming. Paul Smith on the play action is going to find Garrett Mills for the touchdown. He had eight catches for 152 yards. And you say the athletic director
is right. Judy McCloud, she gets credit for the hire, Steve Kragthorpe. She's now with Conference USA headquarters.
Yeah, that's right. Top-ranked USC is looking for its 34th straight win today against arch rival number 11 UCLA. Spencer, I think the Bruins are going to win, but USC is still going to play for the national championship.
Upset's not going to happen. USC is going to win, outscoring first team to 50, folks, wins this one.
Maurice Drew, though, is a back and a return man, much like Reggie Bush. Mm-hmm. He can be a stopper, too, in special teams.
Well, I just think the coaching is going to win out on this one. Pete Carroll, one of the best in America. I think against Carl Durrell, we've not seen how he handles these situations. Coaching is going to win this outscoring game.
All right, good point. Published reports say that Virginia offensive coordinator Ron Prince will be named the new head coach at Kansas State University, replacing the retired Bill Snyder. The 36-year-old Prince will become the fourth African-American coach in Division 1A. Spence, what do you know about this move?
I can tell you this. The deal was done on Tuesday of this week, and if you recall, recall back 2 weeks ago, we told you that David Cutcliffe wasn't going to accept the job at Tennessee as the offensive coordinator until this position was filled. That happened on Monday. This hire happened Tuesday of this week, just like we said it.
Those two agents really knew one another, didn't they? All right, with the Heisman Trophy announcement a week away, Spencer and I will give our picks for the award. Check out our web-exclusive Hot Topic video available this afternoon only on CBSSportsLine.com. And a reminder, the football action does continue tomorrow, an NFL doubleheader. Most of you will see the Bengals and the Steelers. Then later, most will see the Broncos and the Chiefs. It all begins at noon Eastern with the NFL today. Coming up, we'll take a look at the big showdown in Atlanta between LSU and Georgia. Our thoughts on the SEC championship game when the Geico Halftime Report continues.
When you can create your own holiday seafood feast, a meal turns into a celebration. Only Red Lobster lets you create your own favorite holiday feast by combining two or three of your seafood favorites. Choose from 10 signature dishes, including our very best sweet and tender snow crab. And remember, this holiday season, you can treat the seafood lovers on your list to a Red Lobster gift card.
Trust. It's everything. Nobody hands out trust. Talent is one thing. Combine talent with people you trust, and you will walk on that court with a level of respect no one can match.
Ask your financial advisor about the Hartford Mutual Funds, offered by The Hartford, a company built on 194 years of trust. Request a complete prospectus with investment objectives, risks, fees, expenses, and other information to read and consider carefully before investing or sending money.
Okay, when we're all done, I'm calling Mom, Mom calls Glenn, Glenn calls Kim.
I'm calling him.
Glenn calls Kim.
Who's calling me?
I'm calling you.
And I'm calling him.
Exactly. Good.
Wait.
What?
We don't have cell phones.
I don't have a cell phone.
Actually, I don't have a cell phone either.
This holiday, surprise someone in your family with this amazing LG camera phone with flash and speakerphone and get a second one free. Two great gifts for one great price. Call us, visit us online, or stop by a Verizon Wireless communications store.
Everyone know who they're calling?
No.
Great.
Verizon Wireless.
Overstock.com has everything you need. Designer clothes with Christmas bows for underneath the tree. Many things to choose, like auctions, books, and shoes. Diamond rings and lots of things that everyone can use. Oh, 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 the big, big O, Overstock.com. Buy online, saves you time. Gifts for dad and mom.
Overstock.com.
Appears to be a serious hostage situation unfolding.
The unit works undercover around the world.
We are going to take down this plane.
Put your hands on your head and get out of this plane.
Even our wives can never know what we do.
This unit has no name. Other than that, it doesn't exist.
As far as Washington is concerned, this was one hell of an operation by the National Guard.
Secret missions.
You've been training for this moment your entire life.
Shoot guns, jump out of airplanes, and come home to your family. It's damn near perfect.
Secret lives.
You're the one ordered Mac away, so I join you here.
Danger you put me in.
Is this dangerous enough for you?
How are things at the office?
The same as usual. Welcome to the unit.
I'm preparing character development.
Ready?
I'm preparing myself physically.
I'm preparing in foreign affairs.
I'm preparing in computer technology.
I'm preparing in military tactics.
I am preparing to defend America.
And pageantry of Army Navy. A reminder, coming up next at 6 o'clock Eastern, it's the SEC Championship presented by Dr. Pepper.
Here he goes. One man to beat. Touchdown, Georgia. Fires it in the end zone. Caught. Touchdown. LSU has won.
That's next at 6 o'clock Eastern. Now, taking a look at the championship game matchups over the past few years, Georgia and LSU truly, Spencer, have been the elite programs from the East and West really since 2001. And for me, going into this game, LSU's defense is strong. We know that, Spencer. But I think one of the other factors that you have to take into consideration is Justin Vincent. He went for a record 200 yards 2 years ago in this game as a freshman. I think he likes this surface.
That's a good point. You remember back in Oklahoma when he just ripped the Sooners big-time yards. Let me just tell you this. Georgia believes they belong here. Of course, they have the one loss to Florida without DJ Shockley and the one-point loss to Auburn. Many people think Auburn is a very, very good team. In fact, some think they're the best in the country. When you look at the close calls, it tells a big story about this team, this LSU Tiger team. They play close contests, and because of their affinity to win these close matchups, I think this character will come spilling out in this contest. 23 of their last contests, 12 of them have been decided by 7 points or less.
And as good as the defense is for Les Miles, they really haven't turned the ball over for their offense to give them short field, so that is pertinent. For Georgia, this is a club limping home, so to speak, but I think we go back to the cocktail party when Shockley was out. They really haven't gotten in gear since.
They haven't, but I will say this. They've got a brilliant coach in Coach Mark Richt. He's one of the best when you have time to prepare, and I like his preparation, but I just think there's a certain raison d'etre about this team this year with LSU, Hurricane Katrina dealing this. I think LSU will win this by at least 3 points.
I do. I think defense will be the key and also the running of Justin Vincent. Watch out. Thanks for watching the GEICO Halftime Report. Coming up, the second half of Army-Navy. Enjoy the rest of the game on CBS, America's number one network.
CBS Sports presents the GEICO Halftime Report. GEICO.com. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Venetian blinds. That's why GEICO.com is so simple. Or is it because you can get help if you need it and get a free rate quote in minutes? 15 minutes could save you 15% on car insurance. Simple as that.
Hey. So what'd they say?
Oh, same. 3 hours.
We'll still be at my folks for Christmas.
I say we start Christmas right now.
Honey, this isn't very Christmassy.
Sure it is. You're here.
This holiday, tell her she's what makes everything special with a beautiful gift of gold from Kay Jewelers. Because gold is the one language everyone understands. And you can be assured that she'll get the message.
At least Santa's still flying.
Every kiss begins with K.
In a time of hunger, empires fall, heroes rise, and chicken rules. Cows in shining armor, the 2006 Chick-fil-A calendar. Meet Charbroilermen, Reuben Hood, Baldhoof, and more. Just $5 and filled with coupons for delicious food. 'Tis nobler to eat more chicken at Chick-fil-A.
It needs to be a little tighter. Zibby wants a championship. S. Claus. We already got him one.
Elves.
Need a great gift for the holidays? A Home Depot gift card is perfect. It comes in bright new holiday designs, and it's always the right size.
The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
Something smells good. Delivery?
It's not delivery. It's DiGiorno.
DiGiorno? You fixed the oven?
Introducing DiGiorno Microwave Pizza. Rises up in minutes for oven-baked taste in a hurry. It's not delivery. It's DiGiorno Microwave.
So, you don't think your smelly arthritis rub affects anyone's sleep? Try odor-free Aspirin Cream. It's long-lasting and clinically proven to relieve pain. Aspirin-free Aspirin Cream. Now everyone can get the sleep they need.
United States Naval Academy, established in 1845, is the undergraduate college for the Navy. It prepares young men and women to become professional officers in the Navy and Marine Corps. The United States Naval Academy is where America develops the leaders of tomorrow. It is where the core values of honor, courage, and commitment are nurtured, and where the vision of America's future is shaped.
Bill MacArthur, United States Military Academy, class of 1973.
I regret that I cannot be there with you today in person at the Army-Navy game, but I'm pleased to be able to join you from on board the International Space Station 220 miles above the Earth, where I've been living since October 3rd when my crewmate, Valery Tokarev of Russia, and I arrived. As we look down the Earth below and think of you all there in Philadelphia today, we want to leave you with one single thought, one sole idea, to paraphrase Douglas MacArthur, there is no substitute for victory. Go Army, beat baby!
Well, a perfect transition to the halftime ceremony, Reflections from Space, recognizing West Point educated NASA astronauts. 11 astronauts are in attendance, 18 being honored overall. Halftime here in Philadelphia. But Army right now on the short end on the scoreboard. They trail Navy 21-10. Second half is next.
It's unlikely your uniform will ever be retired, but maybe it should be. TIAA CREF, serving the retirement needs of those in the academic, medical, cultural, and research fields. Visit us online to find out how we can serve you. TIAA CREF, financial services for the greater good.
The new Digital Rebel XT. An 8-megapixel, easy-to-use SLR. With virtually no delay when you snap the picture, and with the ability to shoot at 3 frames per second, you'll never miss the opportunity to catch the impossible. The next generation Digital Rebel XT, official camera of the NFL and future NFL players everywhere.
What size is your carbon footprint?
The carbon footprint, that I don't know.
Whatever it is, the whole population of the world, make that a very, very big number.
How much carbon I produce? Is that it?
You mean the effect that my living has on the Earth in terms of the products I consume?
People who visit Geico.com could save hundreds on car insurance, yeah? Big news, yeah? But not if no one hears it, which is why I need you to help spread the word. Otherwise, our big news is nothing but a stray little fact. A wee orphan of truth, wandering the streets looking for a home in someone's ear. Oh, that was easy.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
No, I'm just online paying the credit card bill.
What?
No, I'll be home soon.
We don't want a late fee.
I saw this before.
That's the last one, man. Let's go.
Sometimes you can't help paying late. Avoid late fees with the new Citi Simplicity card. No late fees when you make a purchase each billing period. Citi, live richly.
When you can create your own holiday seafood feast, a meal turns into a celebration. Only Red Lobster lets you create your own favorite holiday feast by combining 2 or 3 of your seafood favorites. Choose from 10 signature dishes, including our very best sweet and tender snow crab. And remember, this holiday season, you can treat the seafood lovers on your list to a Red Lobster gift card.
Officially, the unit does not exist.
We're to obtain the Stingers by force. This is the story of the men who save us and the women who save them.
Every person who knows one more piece of information could get our husbands killed.
Welcome to the unit.
For the start of the second half, Navy with a 21-10 lead on Army. Welcome back. Broadcast booth, everyone.
Iron Eagle, Boomer Esiason. We've actually moved to the overcoats. It's gotten
it's getting a little chilly.
One of us is wearing gloves.
Quarterbacks always want to keep their hands warm.
Talk a little bit about that first half. Lamar Owens, it might be having the game of his life right now in one of the more important moments of his career.
Well, both quarterbacks are playing particularly well, but Owens, it has been his show. He has done it on the ground, making those tough decisions. And remember, I said before the game started, if he's on making decisions like this, and then of course making plays like that leading to this touchdown, then Navy's chances of winning are going to be significantly improved. And he's doing it through the air as well. He's thrown the ball especially nice on that last 2-minute drive that led to that touchdown right there. So it has been the Lamar Owens show thus far.
Halftime stats brought to you by Jeep. Second quarter yards, that's where Navy really turned it up. 221 yards in that second quarter. They've done it basically on the ground throughout, with Owens leading the way. Army has actually led in the time of possession. That kept them in the game in the first half. This Army-Navy game in HDTV, sponsored by Prudential Financial. Navy will kick it off to start out this third quarter. Joey Bullen. Scott Wesley is deep at his own 2-yard line for Army. And it's amazing how the whole complexion of that first half changed on that decision by Bobby Ross and company not to go for it on fourth and about half a yard. They pump the ball, maybe comes right down the field and takes the big lead, 21-10. Wesley comes up short of the 20-yard line. Just moments ago, Dwayne Ballen caught up with Bobby Ross.
Coach Ross, competitive first half, but you have work to do.
We have work to do at the line of scrimmage. We're not playing the way, we're not attacking the line of scrimmage on either side of the ball. Playing on our heels, we got to get that squared away. Plus, we had a couple of errors on breakdowns on critical third down on the backside. We got that corrected, hopefully.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Now, Coach is going to break it down for you. Hand off to Carlton Jones, and Navy was ready. Jake Biles, first man there. He's been involved in so many tackles along with Tyler Tidwell throughout the day. Well, in the first half, offensive leaders for the Black Knights. You talked about the day that Zach Domin has had.
And Zach Domin's playing well. He actually had two balls dropped that would have went for first downs, but his touchdown pass was on third and 18. Not a number that you would think that Army would be able to convert, let alone score a touchdown.
Scott Wesley is in the backfield on a second and 10 after Jones was denied on first down. Here's Domin straight back. Domin has the time, throws it underneath to the fullback Beattie. And Beattie keeps the legs churning as they finally whistle it dead. A 9-yard gain on that pass play. Beattie is the sophomore from Berwick, Pennsylvania. His paternal grandfather, Alan, sergeant in the U.S. Army. His maternal grandfather, Ed Panowski, also in the Army.
Well, here's a huge play for Army to be able to come out of the locker room and get a first down and gain control of the line of scrimmage again on offense is huge for them as they start this second half.
Well, this is a third and one. Jones and Beattie behind Domin. Jones stutter step and it cost him. Rob Caldwell. No first down for Army and the Black Knights forced to punt.
And watch Rob Caldwell. He's the inside linebacker. Does a nice job fighting off the block. And this is a huge play for the defense of Navy. Coming right in and filling the hole. And, you know, that right here could be a game changer.
Yep.
I mean, when you talk about plays like that, it's about momentum, converting third downs and controlling the football, and Navy's defense rose to the occasion.
Well, instead of continuing this drive, now Navy gets the football back after just a couple of minutes of possession for Army. Owen Tolson the punt, Tomlinson lets it drop, and it takes an Army roll. And it sets itself at the 25-yard line. That's where Navy will have its first possession of the second half. 21-10, midshipman in front.
She's absolutely perfect.
And the best part, in each hand, she has a cold Bud Light. Good day, gentlemen.
What a waste of two Bud Lights.
Bud Light.
Great taste, great times.
The Venus de Milo!
No, I gotta tell you, since I've been hurt and missing work, you've been a big help to this family. No, really. The cash we get from Aflac helps us maintain the house, put food on the table. And my Jenny continues with her piano lessons. Yep, this family's doing just fine. And it's all thanks to
Aflac. Ask about it at work.
The all-new Jeep Commander. Introducing the first Jeep 4x4 with 7 passenger seating. It's not just for the city, it's of the city.
It's our Miles of Freedom plan. Now get 2 years of gas and scheduled maintenance and a 5-year or 60,000-mile limited warranty on Jeep Commander.
Officially, the unit does not exist.
We are going to take down this plane. Even our wives can never know what we do. Welcome to the unit.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to the annual Army-Navy game. Navy coming out of the field right now, and at the other end of the stadium, it's Army, the Black Knight, and Navy looks as though it's in trouble. It'll be up to the submarine force to come up with something, and it looks as though they have, from outside of the stadium, secret weapons coming inside but missing the Black Knight. Now they're dropping something, can opener, and look at Navy go to work on the Black Knight. What's inside? Mules!
Go, Navy, Army!
Well, Navy is going to do a deal with the Pixar company at some point. Aflac trivia question. Only 2 Navy coaches have ever won their first 4 games against Army. Who were they? We'll have the answer coming up. Paul Johnson is looking to pull off that feat. He's won 3 in a row in his first 3 games against Army. In fact, he's 6-1 against military academies, and that's often how you are judged. Among the trio, hand off to Adam Ballard. And Ballard fights his way for extra yardage. It's a 4-yard gain. Scruggs, the junior linebacker from Tampa, Florida, able to make that play. Good sideline to sideline linebacker.
And you heard Bobby Ross tell Dwayne Ballon right at halftime, listen, we have to pursue on the backside. We have to stay at home. We have to manage our assignments on defense. And that's something that they did not do, especially those last 2 series of the second half.
2nd and 6. Ballard again. And this time for 2 yards up the middle. So Ballard's been quiet because Owens has done most of the damage. We've seen big plays out of Marco Nelson and Reggie Campbell as well on Navy offense.
Those guys are the slot backs, and remember, they're known as the A-backs, and as Reggie Campbell told us, A's make plays, but they make plays because Lamar Owens has made plays today, Ian. And when you take a look at Lamar Owens, 83 yards on the ground, 2 touchdowns, and 3 of 4 passing for 41 yards in that 2-minute drill at the end of the first half, a pretty impressive day for the senior quarterback for Navy.
Navy, first choice timeout.
Navy uses a timeout with 11:33 remaining in this third quarter. Midshipmen lead it 21-10.
Wrangler 5-star premium denim jeans. Today, them wild night boys that had been away. Built strong. Haven't changed, had much. Built comfortable. But man, I still built right. It's a great. Wrangler 5-star premium denim jeans. Wrangler, real comfortable jeans.
We're a pretty tight group here.
That doesn't happen overnight. People have to learn if they can count on you. You know what I mean?
All the power!
Yes, sir, I do.
Get strength for now, strength for later. Learn more at GoArmy.com.
I got through menopause fine, but my skin took it rough.
Gold Bond Ultimate Moisturizing Lotion. 7 intensive moisturizers and 3 vitamins for extremely dry skin.
Now my skin looks as young as I feel.
Can your lotion do that?
Gold Bond Ultimate Healing. This stuff really works.
Taco Bell's new Chipotle Grilled Stuffed Burrito. Loaded with carne asada steak, chipotle seasoned rice, spicy Southwest chipotle sauce, and 3 melted cheeses. All wrapped up and grilled to go. For the perfect balance of flavor and spice, think outside the bun.
The Home Depot College Football on CBS is sponsored by Jeep, the Hartford Mutual Funds, Chick-fil-A, and by Garmin.
For the 10th straight year, CBS is your broadcast home for Army-Navy midshipmen with the lead, and they face a 3rd and 4 at the 31-yard line. First possession of this second half for Lamar Owens and the Navy offense. They have scored on their first possession of the second half in 7 out of 10 games. Shooting through, Adam Ballard. And a first down inside the Army 40. Stiff arm on Caleb Campbell as we go downstairs, check in with Dwayne Ballard.
Ian, as we have noted throughout the broadcast, this game means so much to so many people around the world. John Henderson was an Army Ranger who died on a mission in Afghanistan back in August. His father, Dr. John Henderson, contacted the Army and asked them if someone would wear his son's Army patch. Now, his son didn't go to West Point, but the Army-Navy game was important in their household. They watched it every single year, and Dr. Henderson told me that his son will be here tonight every time there's a big play.
Now, the patch is being worn by Barrett Scruggs, the linebacker, as Owens keeps it himself. And we talked to Scruggs about this. You know, every Army player wears a patch on his uniform representing a unit in combat. He said he's incredibly honored to wear the patch representing John Henderson Jr., who died in action. You know, John Henderson Sr., you can imagine how emotional a time this is for the family. He always ended conversations with his son by saying Charlie Mike, which is Army talk for continue the mission. And that was his message to Barrett Scruggs today. Hey, continue the mission, get it done on the football field. 5-yard gain for Owens. And Scruggs told us, even if it's a small piece of John Henderson Jr. who is with him today, small piece of a fallen soldier on the field between Army and Navy, it's special.
And Scruggs was certainly visibly moved when he was talking about this. And the Henderson family has certainly left an indelible mark in this young man's life.
Well, right now, Navy is on the move again. 1st and 10 at the 28 of Army. There's Owens. The throw, looking for it all. Almost caught by Tomlinson. Deion Tarver with the coverage.
It hits Deion Tarver right in the back. He never turns around and looks for the football. The ball was perfectly thrown. But if Tarver turns around and looks for it, he has a possible interception right here. The other thing Tomlinson could have done is slow down and let Deion Tarver run into him and force the pass interference call.
Yeah, Texas against Texas on that play. Tomlinson from Arlington, Deion Tarver from San Antonio. Look out, Adam Ballard. Goodbye. Touchdown, Navy.
Well, Ian, we came into this game saying that you have to play assignment football if you are the Army Corps of Cadets, and that's certainly something that we have not seen from the defensive side of the football. And as this Navy running machine is running up and down the field, fullback, quarterback, slot back, everybody getting into the act.
Navy has now cracked 300 yards rushing, and we still have 10-17 to go in the third quarter.
Usually hear that in passing statistics, not running statistics.
28-10, Ballard. He did most of the damage himself on this drive, including the touchdown run for Navy.
Virtually inaccessible, the remote Northern Territory is a fortress of alpine peaks. The terrain so brutal, its beauty has seldom been seen by human eyes.
Only the most adventuresome have ever set foot in this desolate yet picturesque landscape.
much better than the movie.
The all-new 7-passenger Jeep Commander. It's your world. Take command.
It's our Miles of Freedom plan. Now get 2 years of gas and scheduled maintenance and a 5-year or 60,000-mile limited warranty on Jeep Commander.
The financial world is filled with difficult decisions. Who inspires confidence? Where can you turn? Ask your financial advisor about the Hartford Mutual Funds, offered by The Hartford, a company built on 194 years of trust. Request a complete prospectus with investment objectives, risks, fees, expenses, and other information to read and consider carefully before investing or sending money.
In a time of hunger, empires fall, heroes rise, and chicken rules. Cows in shining armor, the 2006 Chick-fil-A calendar. Meet Charbroilermane, Reuben Hood, Boldhoof, and more. Just $5 and filled with coupons for delicious food. 'Tis nobler to eat more chicken at Chick-fil-A.
No matter which team you support, we're all on the same team when it comes to appreciating our troops and their families. America supports you. CBS cares.
Ladies and gentlemen, United States Corps of Cadets.
Well, an impressive lineup, but it hasn't translated onto the football field for Army because Navy has gouged them on the ground. 28-yard touchdown run by Ballard, who had 64 of the 75 yards on that drive. Last four possessions for Navy, all of them have resulted in touchdowns.
You know, we've been talking about Lamar Owens all night long, but this offensive line has done a masterful job of getting up to the linebackers and getting in the way of the Army linebackers from making tackles. And that is so key to keeping those linebackers free from those offensive linemen, and the defensive linemen of Army have been unable to do that thus far.
Ball on the kickoff, Scott Wesley. Army just needs a spark. He was tentative. And Wesley is down at the 16-yard line. Byron McCoy making the play on special teams.
Take a look at the left guard and the left tackle right here. This is Galleon and Pritchett. Watch Pritchett on number 54, Carson Schrode, right here, sealing the inside. And then I really don't know what Rob Davis, the free safety, was thinking about. He ran right past Ballard as he takes it all the way in for the touchdown. And so much deception in this offense and so many subtleties at the offensive line, but great block in that time by the left side of Navy's offensive line.
And now Army's in a 28-10 hole. 10-13 to go in the third. Dobbin, hand off to Jones. And Jones carries for a pickup of two. As we head to New York, let's check in with Tim Brando.
Ion, Homer, Pasadena, here they come. Texas routes Colorado for the second time this season. Mack Brown is soaked. By the way, it's his first ever conference championship as a head coach, believe it or not. Texas wins its 19th straight game, and the USC-UCLA just kicked off. We'll keep you posted.
Well, what a season it's been for the Texas Longhorns as they wrap it up in the Big 12 championship, headed off to Pasadena. Second and eight. This is Jones again. John Chan, first man there, as Jones is able to pick up a yard, maybe two, depending upon the spot. Boomer, we talked to Bobby Ross about this. Last year, when the game got out of hand, what did Army do? They started throwing the football and went against their game plan. Do they do that again here?
Well, he said they're going to stay the course no matter what the situation is. Of course, if they're late in the fourth quarter, into the fourth quarter, that will change. But, you know, this is a situation now, 28-10 with 9 minutes and counting, and third and about eight. You have to be very careful if you're Zach Domin. And he's got to be aware of the play clock there before he gets a penalty called on.
And we'll get the playoff. Domin steps up and throws. Nobody home. He was looking for Corey Anderson. And Keenan Little had the lockdown along the sideline. And the problem, obviously, Boomer, for Army is that they can't stop Navy on the other side of the ball.
And that's why in the first half, going for it on fourth and a half yard was so important. They decided to kick, and really since that time, it hasn't even come close to stopping the Navy running attack.
So another punt for Owen Tolson. Should be excellent field position for Navy. And Tomlinson, who actually had some room in front of him with a fair catch. Navy will have it inside Army territory to open up this drive. 28-10, Miz.
Can I help you find something?
Yeah, I'm looking for a gift for my father-in-law.
Hey, what about a gift card?
Yeah, that'll work.
Good thinking.
A Home Depot gift card is the whole store in a festive little envelope. Now in bright new holiday designs. It's always the right size. Make it holiday at the Home Depot.
The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
Turn left in 300 feet. Arriving at destination.
You're not from around here, are you?
No.
Are you lost?
No.
You need directions anywhere?
No. I already got them.
Garmin, the leader in navigation. We'll take you there.
Create your own holiday feast at Red Lobster. Combine two or three of your seafood favorites from 10 signature dishes, including our tender snow crab. Turn a meal into a celebration this holiday at Red Lobster.
A little black dress is always in style, but even a little dandruff shows. My old dandruff shampoo wasn't into black, so I switched to Selsun Blue.
Doctor recommended for flakes and itch with Alwyn moisturizers for healthier hair and scalp.
Never wear black without the blue. Selsun Blue.
How are things at the office?
The same as usual. Welcome to the unit.
The Home Depot College Football on CBS is sponsored by Jeep, the official vehicle of the 106th Army-Navy game.
Back in Philadelphia, Navy 28, Army 10. And coming up tomorrow, the NFL on CBS. Doubleheader action. Many of you will see Cincinnati at Pittsburgh, Tennessee at Indianapolis. Early game, then late Denver at Kansas City. It all begins with the NFL today. Tomorrow, 12 o'clock. Greg, Dan, Janet, and Boomer. We got to change that order. We got to get you in the front.
No, no, no. I'm over there at the wingman
seat. Oh, you're the wingman? Okay. Yes. We'll keep you right where you're at there.
I like where I'm sitting. Actually, to be honest with you, tomorrow we spent a lot of time talking about Indianapolis Colts and the possibility of them going 16-0. What a start for the Colts. 11-0 at this point.
On first down, Owens airs it out. And one hopper to Mick Yakitis. Incomplete. Well, the Aflac trivia question. Only two Navy coaches have won their first four games against Army. Who were they? The answers, Wayne Harden, who actually won his first five, and George Welch. Second down, handoff to Ballard. No, it's Owens on a keeper. They're going to keep you guessing up here in the booth.
I don't mean to laugh at you, but you remember we were talking about the deception that this offense brings, but the subtleties that are going on at the offensive line, and it's important for Army to read their keys, and they haven't done a very good job of that tonight. And you know, Navy right here, I mean, they could just run you into submission if they already haven't. I mean, they have just done such a great job of controlling the line of scrimmage.
But let me ask you though, why don't more Division I teams run this offense?
The alumni don't want to see this offense.
Well, Owens just went to the sideline, and Brian Hampton, the junior backup quarterback, checks in. And it's Hampton. It doesn't matter who it is. A first down for Navy inside the 30. John Wright making the tackle around the ankles to bring down Hampton.
All right, so you're standing on a sideline. You're freezing because it's about 25 degrees. You take the ball and you run with it. Coming off the bench and make a key play. for your offense. So that's exactly what you pay the back. Well, he didn't get paid, but that's what the backup quarterback's supposed to be doing.
Well, Hampton, who has played slot back, kick returner, punt returner, got a little bit of everything for this Navy team. Marco Nelson takes a shot, and it was Caleb Campbell who leveled him, a two-yard gain.
We were talking about why don't more teams run this option. You know, alumni want to see the ball in the air. You know, you want to see passing. They want to see the ball down the field. And, you know, this is exactly the type of thing that you'd want to do for an academy. You know, you bring this type of offense here. The teams that you play don't see it very often. And it's very difficult to simulate in a week's worth of practice, or even 2 weeks' worth of practice for that matter.
Second and eight. Ballard. And a crowd along that line led by Tony Fusco. He's the sophomore from Watertown, Connecticut. Owens came off limping just slightly. Looked like he took himself out of there. And here's Brian Hampton in for Owens. And Hampton's got some ability as well. Could be the heir apparent for this job with Owens graduating in the spring.
Well, the way it goes here, he would be the heir apparent because he's a junior. He'd be a senior next year, and he'd be the starter in his senior year.
Yeah, that's how it works. As Hampton, ball may have come loose. Army is fighting for it underneath that pile. And a little pushing and shoving after the play. Seth Lotz, Luke Pell were down there. And that was the case of Brian Hampton doing exactly what Lamar Owens did, waiting for his turn, as Craig Candido and Aaron Polanco ran this offense with great precision.
And back on comes Owens, as it is now fourth and three. So this is a big play for this Army defense right here.
Lamar Owens back under center on a fourth and three. Pitch. Off the toss, Nelson shredding Army's defense for another first down. That's a 7-yard gain for Nelson.
And Barrett Scruggs comes back here and hits Nelson right in the chops. Watch this. Bang. And he gets rid of the ball perfectly. As Navy makes another first down, and again, it goes back to those decisions that Lamar Owens is making. And when you think of decisions, you think of quarterbacks and passing games, but not here. You have to be able to read the defensive line, the linebackers, and how they're pursuing. And you make that decision when you pitch and or hand it off, in this case, like the Ballard right up the middle. I mean, all of that is dependent on how he is seeing the field. And tonight, he has been on. Very few wrong decisions.
That's an 8-yard gain. Navy has won the last three games against Army by a combined score of 134-31. As far as the red zone, what Navy has done this year, 29 touchdowns in 44 trips. And they are just adding another chapter to this storied rivalry. Handoff. Ballard. And finally goes down. Fusco was in there among that group for Army. And since that good showing early on from the Army defense, Boomer, back-to-back possessions, did a nice job handling the triple option. Since then, this is the fifth, sixth possession in a row where they're going to put points on the board.
And remember, Paul Johnson was telling us, you know, I want to see how you're playing me. And then when you start, I figure that out, then all of a sudden I'm going to start making adjustments, and the adjustments that Paul Johnson had made tonight have been right on.
Ballard almost got to the goal line. Comes up just a little bit shy.
This is where it gets fun, Ian. It's down low, it's down and dirty, it's in the mud, and look at that explosion by Antron Harper. He's the right guard who just takes Tony Fusco and moves him back. As I'm going to tell you, Adam Ballard's going to hear it from Paul Johnson because he's still running high.
Kaysen Schrode made a touchdown saving tackle. They'll try it again. Ballard. And Owens took a shot. As the play had developed, Rod Davis with a smack on Owens. No penalty markers. How about penalties today? How many do you think? One against Navy. They come in among the least penalized teams in college football, averaging 4.5 penalties per game, 5 against Army.
Well, what would you expect?
They're disciplined.
You would think so, right?
On a third and goal. Owens. He's got it. Touchdown, Navy. John McCain likes this one. At the top of our show today, him and Norman Schwarzkopf going head-to-head. And the passion that they feel for their military academies. McCain, a Navy guy. Schwarzkopf, of course, West Point grad. But right now, all the bragging rights belong to the midshipmen. Yeah, keep on lifting. 35-10. What a roll this Navy offense is on.
You didn't type in your password.
Don't have to. Biometrics.
What?
Wherever I am, I just swipe, password goes in, I'm connected. Biometrics.
Oh, bionic finger, cool. It's like 10 times stronger than a regular finger.
No, it's for passwords.
No, it's more like na 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 na
na na na na na na na na.
Better.
Secure wireless, made easy. Only on a ThinkPad with Intel Centrino mobile technology.
Can I help you find something?
Yeah, I'm looking for a gift for my father-in-law.
Hey, what about a gift card?
Yeah, that'll work.
Good thinking.
A Home Depot gift card is the whole store in a festive little envelope. Now in bright new holiday designs. It's always the right size. Make it holiday at the Home Depot.
The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
Commander-in-Chief's trophy at stake here today in Philadelphia. And Navy with another impressive drive, capped off by Lamar Owens, his third rushing touchdown of the day. That ties a career high for him. Owens has hit the 100-yard mark on the ground as well on 15 carries.
Well, if you're a senior and you're playing in this game, this is the type of game that you want to have. It's a game to remember. It's a game of a lifetime. And certainly Owens, who himself is very quiet when he came in and met with us, much like Zach Dahmen, the quarterback for Army, was, has really played one heck of a football game.
Well, the one thing with Owens, I would say, though, quiet, yes, but there was an intensity there that you could tell. There's a fire there. He said he was ready to be the guy setting the tone for this team. He wanted the challenge of becoming the leader, and he has certainly fulfilled that challenge, stepping in for big shoes left by Polanco and Candido. Wesley couldn't handle it initially, able to recover and get the ball to the 21 for Army. The members of this secret military unit risk their lives every day, but it's their families who make the biggest sacrifice. Meet the men who save us and the women who save them. The unit, coming soon to CBS, America's number one network. Navy 35, Army 10, and we've got 3:05 to go on this third quarter. Carlton Jones, who went over the 1,000-yard rushing mark earlier today. Dahmen's looking to throw, airs it out, and a little too much air on it as he overthrows his intended receiver, Walter Hill. USC, UCLA, let's go to New York. Tim Brando.
Interesting reverse in strategy for USC today. Lane Kiffin, their offensive coordinator, opens the drive with seven straight running plays. Matt Leinart misses Steve Smith on a third down pass, incomplete. Mario Donello connects on a 35-yarder. Leinart was 0 for 5 on the drive. 3-0 Trojans. Ian.
All right, Timmy B, we'll keep you updated throughout the second half here. 3 minutes to go in the third. Fake the handoff. Dahmen. Rushers coming, and Dahmen finds Hill over the middle. Walter Hill lost his mom, Barbara, to cancer back in October. Hill able to bring it in as we go downstairs, check in with Dwayne Bell.
Thank you. I'm with Senator John McCain, who, of course, went to the Naval Academy and a veteran. Senator McCain, so far, things are going Navy's way.
Yeah, it really is. And, of course, as a Naval Academy graduate, I'm happy. But Bobby Ross deserves great credit. He's a great coach. He's got a great team. They won four in a row and like to see it a little more competitive.
Senator, what is your biggest memory from this game?
Probably the first time I came here when I was my first year, and it was over at Kennedy Stadium, 100,000 people. It was really great. And that year we went to the Sugar Bowl. George Welch was the quarterback. That shows you how old I am.
But can we overemphasize the importance of this game to the military personnel? And you're someone that's been in the military around the world and been in harm's way.
All over the world, including Baghdad and Kabul, and all over where men and women are in harm's way. They're watching this game. God bless them.
Thank you, Senator McCain. Ian?
All right, thanks so much. And it does echo the mutual respect that these two academies have for one another.
Well, there's no question. It's opponents for 60 minutes, as they say, but comrades for life. And that is so true. And both of these respective schools want to win this football game in the worst way, but at the end of the day, they shake hands and they respect each other and the effort that they put forth, and more importantly, that they know that they'll be together as teammates once they leave their academies. So there's so much poignancy that is attached to this game, I think, and if you haven't been around it, you really can't appreciate it. But when you go to the schools, you go to the academies, you meet the finest that we have to offer as a country, and you listen to their stories, you listen to where they come from, all backgrounds, all colors. I mean, just so many wonderful kids that makes you proud to be an American when you get a chance to talk to them.
On a first and 10 for Army. Give is to Jones. Shake and bake move to the outside. And Jones driven towards the sideline. Greg Thrasher got a stiff arm from Jones. Famous Navy alums, Alan Shepard, class of 44. President Jimmy Carter, 46. James Lavelle, the class of 52. How about Ross Perot, class of 1953. And Roger Staubach, class of 1965.
And right now for Army, I think they basically are throwing their playbook out. They're starting to throw the ball a little bit more. It's now time for desperation and desperate measures, and that's exactly what they're employing here on this last drive, on this drive here.
25-point disparity with a minute 27 to go, third quarter. Zing it out to the flat, and Jones comes up just short of the 20-yard line. Number of defenders in the air to help bring him down. A gain of 8 for Jones in the passing game.
And Zach Domin is 14 of 19, 142 yards, and you know, you just got to get in and out of the huddle. You got to have a sense of urgency here. You don't have to force the ball downfield. A couple times he's hit the backs on wide patterns behind the line of scrimmage. So this is a chance, you know, to really finish this game strong. Continue to play hard. Don't ever give up. That's obviously Bobby Ross's motto, and he's going to watch these players closely to make sure that they are still fighting to the end. I would expect nothing less.
There's Domin, a short drop. Touch pass, and fortunate that he didn't do further damage. Knocked away by McGowan, looking for Jacob Murphy, who was the target along the sideline. 22 seniors making their final appearance in an Army uniform, or as they're called at West Point, firsties. They were hoping to end their career with a lasting memory today against Navy.
Well, I'll just be careful here and say we got a whole other quarter to go, so anything can happen in a football game. But, you know, Zach Domin again, very impressive today, has had a nice game, and really it's the Army defense, I think, that has let the team down.
On a third and 2. Domin, pitch, Wesley, he's got a first down. Able to bang his way out along the perimeter for a gain of 3. And 33 seconds remain now in the third quarter.
Remember, we asked Scott Wesley, why do you wear number 82? Well, you know, I was moved from wide receiver to running back, and that was the only jersey my mom had. I didn't want to force her to go buy another one, so I kept the number.
So thoughtful, though.
Yes.
And it's a little strange, as a play-by-play guy, a color commentator, you see 82 down there in the backfield. You say, am I seeing it wrong? It's just not a sight that you're accustomed to. Carrying the football. Here's Domin, new set of downs. Floats it for Jones. Jones makes a move. Here's Jones. taking it for the touchdown.
And a perfect play to call in this situation, Ian, as the Army was going down the field, throwing the passes, and the Navy was bringing the pass rush. A great time for a screen call, and perfectly executed by Carlton Jones, Zach Dahmen, and his offensive linemen as they led him down the field.
And a sign of life for this Army offense. Sixth consecutive game with a touchdown for the highly decorated senior Carlton Jones. Extra point, Kaney. Late stages of this third quarter, a nine-play, 79-yard drive. The end result, a touchdown for Jones through the air.
Hey.
Hey, so what'd they say?
Oh, same, 3 hours.
We'll still be at my folks for Christmas.
I say we start Christmas right now.
Oh, honey, this isn't very Christmassy.
Sure it is. You're here.
This holiday, tell her she's what makes everything special with a beautiful gift of gold from Kay Jewelers. Because gold is the one language everyone understands. And you can be assured that she'll get the message.
At least Santa's still flying.
Every kiss begins with Kay.
I'm Dale Earnhardt Jr. Welcome to a new generation of Wrangler.
Fits, new comfort, new styles. Wrangler Jeans Company, a new generation of Wrangler. New fits, new comfort, new styles.
Officially, the unit does not exist. And we answer only to one man.
I need some explanation.
Ask for the president. Welcome to the unit.
Up tonight on CBS, it all begins with SEC Championship College Football, followed by the Academy of Country Music 40th anniversary celebration tonight on CBS. We'll see if Navy has a celebration later tonight. We still have a few seconds to go in this third quarter, and then the entire fourth quarter here in Philadelphia. Army took 3 minutes and 6 seconds to go 79 yards and an 18-yard touchdown reception for Carlton Jones. Zach Dahmen's second touchdown pass of the day.
And what Army needs right now, they need a turnover. Some good field position to see if they can tack another touchdown on the board.
Koenig boots it in the air. Campbell moves forward to catch it at the 12. Campbell breaks one tackle. And thrown down at the 33-yard line by Kevin Apaku. End of the third quarter with a score, Navy 35, Army 17. You're watching the Home Depot College Football on CBS, America's number one network.
Hey, you didn't type in your password.
Don't have to. Biometrics.
What?
Wherever I am, I just swipe, password goes in, I'm connected. Biometrics.
Oh, bionic finger, cool. It's like 10 times stronger than a regular finger.
No, it's for passwords.
No, it's more like
na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na.
Na-na-na-na-na-na-na.
Better.
Secure wireless, made easy. Only on a ThinkPad with Intel Centrino mobile technology.
Georgia Bulldogs battle the LSU Tigers for the SEC Championship on CBS Sports.
This is CBS, America's most watched network.
Shop Scioto Valley's holiday celebration.
For the game room you've always dreamed of.
Get a slate pool table for just $8.99.
Choose from 10 models priced under $19.99.
Game and poker tables from $8.88.
A 300-piece poker chip set, just $14.
A huge selection of deluxe bars and canopy bars start at just $4.88.
You'll also get huge savings on air hockey, electronic arcade games, and Vegas-style slot machines.
Only at Scioto Valley.
We have all the fun.
The time has come to get in the spirit. Your best holiday buy is here. Karastan for Christmas at Right Rug. Now for just $265 installed and in your home before Christmas Day. This year, your best holiday bargain is a bargain on the best. Every Karastan selection is on sale now. Yours from just $265 with all in-stock selections installed by Christmas. So get in the spirit and save on Karastan for Christmas right now at Right Rug.
I'm glad you're driving. I hate this stuff.
The law calls for every driver to have car insurance. But weather like this demands it. 1-800-SAFE-AUTO. We keep you legal for less.
The Broncos versus the Chiefs, Sunday at 4 on 10 TV.
United States Military Academy, H. Norman Schwarzkopf, class of 1956.
United States Naval Academy, John McCain, class of 1958. Go Navy.
Go Army.
Beat Army.
Beat Navy.
Well, it's been a Navy kind of day so far, with the mids up front in a 35-17 score over Army. Ian Eagle, Boomer Esiason, Dwayne Ballin with you, the rest of our CBS crew.
That's not one of our guys.
No, no, I don't believe he's on the crew, but he's creative. First play of this fourth quarter, and Navy takes over with a first and 10 at the 33-yard line. Hand off, Ballard through the middle. Ballard will take it all the way for the Navy touchdown. A dominant day on the ground for the Migs. 67 yards for Ballard. Can you say Kyle Echol?
Kyle who? I have to tell you that there's really nothing to analyze here other than the fact that nobody touched him. He went right up the middle of the field, and nobody touches Ballard. Nobody.
Extra point, Joey Bullock. Adam Ballard. 15 carries, 161 yards, two touchdowns. Six straight touchdowns now for Navy.
Coming to CBS.
You're gonna like these guys, though. They're a pretty good crew. Everybody listen up. This is LeVon.
Hey, LeVon, I'm Winty.
You're on the 120 today.
How are you?
So if there's anything you need, just ask these guys. They'll take care of it, all right?
Okay.
Welcome aboard.
Thank you.
You ever been around anything this fast before?
Yeah, in my last job.
Get strength for now, strength for later. Learn more at GoArmy.com.
At Geico.com, you can handle all your car insurance needs online. It's so easy, a caveman could do it.
Seriously, we apologize. We had no idea you guys were still around.
Yeah, next time maybe do a little research.
Gentlemen, are we ready to order?
I'll have the roast duck with the mango salsa.
I don't have much of an appetite, thank you.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Time right now for our Geico scoring summary recap.
Scoring recap.
And we'll start things off with Army, Koenig 32-yard field goal. And then Navy takes the lead. Campbell, 54 yards. A sign of things to come for Navy. Army comes right back, showing resiliency. Trimble, he waited for this one, but it finally came down for 30 yards. Army takes the lead. Then Owens took control. 28-yard touchdown run, 14-10. And Navy then did not stop. Owens from 1 yard away, a 21-10 lead for Navy. Ballard, the fullback, rumbles 28 yards for pay dirt. Owens to the other side for 1 yard, 35-10. Dominic, his second touchdown of the day through the air to Carlton Jones. But after they kick off, first play from scrimmage, Ballard. Did anybody touch him? Anybody?
Nobody touched him. You don't get that free in practice.
And you know what? You're allowed to smile after that.
Well, you could smile on that sideline, but on the other sideline, they have to be exasperated because this is not the way that you play defense. And I would think that John Mumford is just searching for answers. The defensive coordinator of Army on the sideline, and of course Bobby Ross is just probably, you know, I know he's livid. I know how Bobby gets, and boy, I'll tell you, he lays it all out on the field. And we talked to him about, you know, his age and what he expects for Army in the future and how long he's going to be here. And I mean, he kind of said to us, he said, listen, you know, I get tired after games because I leave it all out on the field. And you know, he's a great coach, but he's got to certainly shore up this run defense if they ever think that they can beat Navy.
Well, the first goal that he set out to achieve when he took over the Army program, to win the Commander-in-Chief's trophy. And they came in today with a chance to do exactly that after beating Air Force earlier this season. But after a slow start from Navy, wow, have the Mids ever woken up. We're going to New York. Let's check in with Tim Brandon.
And I'm going to take you to the West Coast, out to the L.A. Coliseum. Matt Leinart did complete a pass in this drive, an 8-yarder to Dwayne Jarrett. Southern Cal up 10-0. One half of the Rose Bowl pairing is set with Texas. We'll see about USC.
All right, Timmy, 42-17. Navy has the lead on Zach Domin and the Army Black Knights. It's been lopsided each of the last 3 years in this series. And you feel like Army's improved. You're not just saying that. But on the scoreboard, it's not going to show that. Domin, he got pounded. Tyler Tidwell. And the junior from Edmond, Oklahoma, applying that pressure among those there with John Chan. Their work is top secret. Their missions and their very existence are classified. American soldiers working undercover and around the world, the heroes of the unit, coming soon to CBS, America's number one network. On a 2nd and 10, after the incomplete pass from Domin. Domin, deep drop, and a soft toss over the middle to Trimble. It's going to be short of a first down. He picks up modest gain, 6 yards on 2nd down, setting up 3rd and 4 for Army.
And the one thing that Zach Domin has to do now, not only for protecting himself, but to be successful, it's get back there, make those quick decisions, get the ball out of your hand, because the Navy defensive line, you know, there is no regard for the run at this point. It's all about getting sacks, getting hits on the quarterback, and for the most part, the Army offensive line has done a good job protecting him tonight.
Agreed. 3rd and 3. Just a minute gone by in this fourth quarter. Wesley in the backfield. Domin throwing. Incomplete. Josh Dobby, the sophomore from Dover, Florida, in a matchup with a linebacker, David Mahoney. And it's Mahoney who wins out, as Dobby may have heard some footsteps.
And when you're running the football the way Navy is, it does make it a very frustrating game for Army, who wants to move the ball passing in this situation. Much harder to complete those passes than to hand it off to a fullback who goes untouched.
Tomlinson standing at midfield. And Tolson did not get all of this one, but he does get a favorable roll. And it stops just outside the 45-yard line of Navy. 42-17, Midshipman in control.
Grand Cherokee SRT8. With the power to go from 0 to 60 in under 5 seconds. It's a force of nature.
Yeah, great. Bye.
The world's first phone with iTunes. Only $149.99. Only from Singular. Raising the bar.
100 years ago, you were living out here in a desert chopping each other's heads off, and that's exactly where you're going to be in another 100.
Why is it some dirty little secret that it's in America's interest to do business overseas?
Kill someone that hasn't done anything wrong.
You will have squandered the greatest natural resource in history.
Our real client, after all, is us.
Syriana, rated R, starts December 9th.
The Home Depot College Football on CBS is sponsored by Jeep, Singular, Aflac, and by the U.S. Navy.
Here in Philadelphia, 79th time this game has been played in the city of brotherly love. Navy 42, Army 17. Now the midshipmen take over, first and 10 from the 45. Brian Hampton is back in there. In place of Lamar Owens, Hampton spills out after a gain of 3. Deion Tarver slides in to make the tackle. Next, big time bowl dreams, conference title. They're there for the taking. Georgia and LSU, the SEC championship presented by Dr. Pepper. What a season for the Bayou Bengals. 10-1. Georgia has been outstanding as well at 9-2. That's coming up here on CBS. On the handoff, Ballard gets the call. And it's going to be about a yard and a half shy of a first down. That's a 5-yard gain for Ballard, adding to his total. Last 6 possessions, I don't know if you notice a trend here, Boomer.
It's gotten easier as it's gone on. I don't know, but you know, the fact is when you get run on like the Army is getting run on here, that is not a way to lose. I mean, that's how you want to win. That means you're controlling the entire game, and that's exactly the way it's been for Navy since the second part of the second quarter. And I think this is going to be against Navy right here. It's going to be a false start, but
Pearl to the snap. False start, offense, number 63. It's a 5-yard penalty. Still third down.
You know, Aaron, you and I were talking this week, and I was saying, you know, I just don't know if Army can stop this running game. Mm-hmm. I'm just not sure if they can do it. I mean, they actually have gotten better as the season's gone on, but this is such a precision running game by Navy, and Lamar Owens was on from the get-go. He made all the right decisions, and as you can see right there, 416 yards of offense on the ground is pretty impressive.
Hampton caught by John Wright. And it is a new season high rushing total for Navy today. They just backed up 414 yards on the ground overall. Paul Johnson has some choice words for Brian Hampton. I think he's planting the seed for 2006.
Well, he can't yell at Ballard. Ballard had a heck of a day today, so he's going to yell at somebody, right?
So I guess he believes Hampton is capable of much, much more. That's what we're told, that Johnson's going to get on the guys that he knows can do better. Ball was loose as a flag came down, thrown at the 23-yard line. And down the field, Reggie Campbell may have made some contact with Scott Wesley. We'll see if that's what the penalty marker indicates. With 11:43 left to go in this fourth quarter. Navy with a chance to win their third straight Commander-in-Chief's Trophy.
I think it's a little bit more than a chance right now, don't you?
Mm-hmm. Well, I mentioned that in the third quarter. You jump all over me. Hey, we still got a quarter to play. I can't win.
Kick catch interference. Number 7 on the kicking team. 15 yards from the end of the kick. First down.
Now, you got to think of my thought process here. I played on a lot of teams that lost a lot of games, so I always thought I was in it. Yeah, I was never out of it.
Your thought process is that you're a contrarian. That's your thought process. Whatever I say, you're taking the opposite. I've learned that in our 3 years together.
Imagine simultaneously tracking over 100 enemy targets on land, sea, and in the air from thousands of miles away. It's the most powerful weapon system ever invented. It's called Aegis, and it's just one of the amazing technologies you'll find only in the United States Navy. Navy, accelerate your life. Log on to the Life Accelerator at Navy.com.
They arrived this morning.
On your ThinkPads?
Yeah, a wireless workhorse. It's got Intel, stainless hinges, titanium composite, hard drive protection, rock solid.
Slick. Who gets the first one?
I work up real sweat, you know?
Phil.
Phil.
Klutz Proof Wireless.
I'm okay.
Only on a ThinkPad with Intel Centrino mobile technology.
Some brewers look out their windows and see smokestacks. Some don't.
Rocky Mountain High, Colorado.
Create your own holiday feast at Red Lobster. Combine two or three of your seafood favorites from 10 signature dishes, including our tender snow crab. Turn a meal into a celebration this holiday at Red Lobster.
They are the men who save us and the women who save them.
Every person who knows one more piece of information could get our husbands killed.
Welcome to the unit.
Navy 42, Army 17, 18 seniors in this game for Navy. Adam Ballard is a sophomore with a bright future. Lamar Owens, a senior, still one more game to play. Colorado State, they meet in the Poinsettia Bowl, December the 22nd in San Diego, being played at Qualcomm, not far from the Naval Amphibious Base in Coronado. Here's Dahman throwing. And drop. Walter Hill unable to haul it in. Boom with a view. Let's relive that.
Well, I said when Navy had the ball, Owens had to be on, and certainly he has been. And the D-line needed to protect the linebackers of Army. That's something that they didn't do, and that's why Owens was so good. And, of course, play smash mouth football, but when you get down like they are down now, you completely throw that out the window. And then you needed to control Carlton Jones if you were Navy. For the most part, they've done that, but I think it's because the Navy offense has been on the field so much, controlling the line of scrimmage and controlling the ball, especially in the second half, that the Army offense really hasn't had an opportunity.
On a second and 10 now for Dahman. Steps up, set up the screen. And Jones, a 2 yard game. Keenan Little making the stop. Well, for Lamar Owens, he has carried it 15 times, 100 yards, 3 touchdowns, Boomer.
Yeah, and Reggie Campbell was the recipient of one of Owens' pitches as he took on the blocker. So Owens has done it not only with himself, but has also been unselfish, read the defense perfectly, and pitched it to his slot backs, and has given it to Adam Bullard when he needed to, and he's done really everything that you could have asked of a quarterback in this offense.
Now a third and 8. Thrown down by Chan. John Chan, his 6th sack of the season. The junior from Pleasant Hill, California, who won 3 national high school championships at De La Salle High School, one of the famed programs in the country.
The only thing I can tell you is that the Army players would be pretty lucky that this game isn't being played in the middle of the season, because Bobby Ross would kill them at practice the next 3 weeks.
You know this from experience.
I know it from experience.
Tomlinson, the return man. And Tomlinson goes down at the 36-yard line. 41-yard punt. Julius Myers downfield to make the play on special teams. And we'll step aside. Go Navy, beat Army seems to be the credo that's playing out.
With Vonage, I talk as much as I want and pay a lot less. It's just $24.99 a month, and
That includes voicemail, caller ID, three-way calling, and a lot more. The voice quality's great, and I even get to keep my same phone and phone number. I've had Vonage for 4 months. Should have gotten it a long time ago.
We're not out to change the world, just the way you talk to it. Sign up now and get your first month free. Call 1-800-939-4VON. High-speed internet connection required.
Virtually inaccessible, the remote Northern Territory is a fortress of alpine peaks. The terrain so brutal, its beauty has seldom been seen by human eyes.
Only the most adventuresome have ever set foot in this desolate yet picturesque landscape.
This is much better than the movie.
The all-new 7-passenger Jeep Commander. It's your world. Take command.
It's our Miles of Freedom plan. Now get 2 years of gas and scheduled maintenance and a 5-year or 60,000-mile limited warranty on Jeep Commander.
Mmm, something smells good. Delivery?
It's not delivery. It's DiGiorno.
DiGiorno? You fixed the oven?
Introducing DiGiorno Microwave Pizza. Rises up in minutes for oven-baked taste in a hurry. It's not delivery. It's DiGiorno Microwave.
You are black, even a little dandruff shows.
That's why more people are switching from ordinary dandruff shampoo to Celsin Blue, doctor recommended for flakes and itch, with aloe and moisturizers for healthier hair and scalp. Make the switch.
Never wear black without the blue. Celsin Blue.
Officially, the unit does not exist. And we answer only to one man.
I need some explanation.
Ask for the president. Welcome to the unit.
The all-time series is tied 49-49 and 7. Navy hasn't led since 1991. That's been a change within 10 minutes of football left on the clock. And handoff, Ballard breaking tackles. Adam Ballard finally brought down as he took it into Army territory to the 43-yard line. And time right now for Red Lobster, presenting today's scholar athlete. It's Rob Davis of Army. Three tackles today. Rob, a systems engineering major out of Charlotte, North Carolina. And carrying a 3.52 GPA. Red Lobster's commitment to the investment of our future is shown today by donating $1,000 to Army's General Scholarship Fund. Here's Ballard getting another carry. That's a 5-yard pickup for the fullback as we head back to New York. Tim Brando.
Ian and Boomer, how about a 97-yard drive for USC all on the ground? They lead 17-0 now as Lindell White scores. He came in because Reggie Bush needed a blow. Bush has 185 rushing yards on just 13 carries already.
Well, we can relate, at least a little bit. You know, normally you throw out that figure, 97 yards all on the ground or 91 yards. Yeah, we know what you're talking about from what we've seen here today, the way Navy has controlled the ground game, and Brian Hampton doing it himself for the Miz.
I have a feeling that it's a little bit quicker out there on the West Coast than it is here, but I don't know how much more effective it could be because Navy has been literally running on all cylinders.
497 yards of total offense, 456 have come via running plays. And a first and 10 at the 23. Trey Hines. Hines is a junior. Douglasville, Georgia native. Peter Harrington making the tackle for Army.
And you were asking me whether or not Navy would not, you know, run up the score. I said, well, you know, it is an option offense. They're going to run the ball anyway. Right. They're not going to throw it. And I guess the way that they would signify that they're not trying to run up the offense is by putting the backups in, and that's exactly what we're seeing right now.
Don't forget, second half of the doubleheader coming up. College football with the SEC championship here on CBS. Second and 7. Motion man McCoy. And McCoy cutting to the outside. Caleb Campbell cuts him down. Big hitter out of that strong safety position. The second unit offensive line is now out there for Navy. The total yards about as lopsided as you can get. Now 501 officially for Navy.
Somehow Army has got to figure out this Navy option, and they're gonna have to do it, you know, in about a year's time, because I don't necessarily know that Bobby Ross can put himself through one of these again like this. I mean, again, run defense is really the staple of any really good football team, and we thought that Army's run defense is getting better, but Navy has definitely exposed them tonight.
Here's Hampton cutting it upfield, and spins out of bounds. No, no matter what the final score is, Boomer, I think we both agree that Army took a step forward this season from a year ago, but if they would have somehow found a way to win here, that would have been a major step forward for the program heading into the offseason.
Well, we talked about it. They won at Air Force this year, and we asked a lot of those players, what was that plane ride like coming back from Air Force? And they all said we had never experienced anything like that because they hadn't had any big wins like that. So there's no question that the transformation has started at Army, but you could see that Navy is so far ahead of them.
And on the handoff for Hines, not much there. Tony Fusco making the tackle for a loss on the play of 1 yard. And for Paul Johnson, you know, he put it in pretty clear terms for us when we asked him about Army and his impressions of the program this year. He said, you know, first and foremost, nothing but respect for Bobby Ross and what he's accomplished, what he's doing. But he said the biggest key is they finally accepted the notion they have to run the football at a military academy to be successful. They're just not able to recruit the kind of quarterbacks you need to win games through the air. And that's just not for Army, but for Navy and for Air Force as well. Brian Hampton caught by John Wright.
Yeah, I don't see Army going to this style of offense, a spread option, the way that Navy runs it, but they were more disciplined. They gave the ball to Carlton Jones. He was their guy this year, and certainly Scott Wesley was a big part of that. Their offensive line maturity as the season got on, they got better. But when I look at this game tonight, I kind of look at a couple different things, but most importantly, it's the run defense. That's the thing that every team has got to get good at if they want to become a very good team and get to the next level.
On third and goal, the toss, loose football. Eddie Martin coughed it up. At the 6 yard line, Army takes over. Martin, a junior and a former quarterback.
I'm feeling that Martin's not going to want to go over to the sideline to see Paul Johnson as he takes the pitch from Hampton. And it looks like Rob Davis puts his helmet right on the football. So not only is he smart, he's a good tackler too. Look at that.
Now, how many mistakes have we actually seen here today from Navy?
Well, you know, the mistakes to the naked eye, one.
Yeah,
that's it. All the little things that Paul Johnson, you know, he'll be screaming at his players for something. I'm sure there was a bunch of those, but pretty hard to argue with 42 points.
6 minutes to play. The throw to Corey Anderson. And Anderson ducks out of bounds at around the 15-yard line. Coming soon to CBS, a military unit so top secret, even their wives can't know it exists. Undercover missions and dark secrets are at stake on The Unit. Coming soon to CBS, America's number one network. Well, the Navy blue and gold for the midshipmen came in averaging 31.7 points per game. They put up 42 today. And with 5:53 to go, Zach Dahman looking to throw it. Dahman angling to the sideline. When we talked to Zach, he was 5 years old, and he said, I was actually fast back then. So I played a little bit of running back. But the next year, I played quarterback full-time at the age of six, and he has never played any other position in his life since that time.
And I asked him about this being his last game, and I think there was a little bit of emotion there.
Yep.
And listen, he's been through these games. He started, you know, since he was a freshman. And unfortunately, you know, he's never beaten Navy, and he's got to live with that. But I thought this year was his best year, and I thought this was his best Army-Navy game by far.
Oh, no doubt. No doubt. Dahman, 18 of 27, 178 yards, two touchdowns. Dahman throws. And a catch made by Ulikowski. Oh, he lost the ball as it came off his back out of bounds. Well, the famous Army alums, it's a long, distinguished list. Robert E. Lee, class of 1829. Ulysses S. Grant, former president, class of 1843. Douglas MacArthur, 1903. General George S. Patton, class of 1909. President Dwight Eisenhower, class of 1915. And Omar Bradley, also in that class of 1915.
They could have used General Patton for a halftime speech, don't you think?
Could have helped. Could have helped. 5:25 to go in the fourth. And here's Donovan. Pocket holds up. Almost picked off. He was looking for Hill, but an errant pass. And Joe Silk, the junior from Claymont, Delaware, one of a pair of brothers on this team. His brother Larry Silk is the nose guard. For Army, I think the difficult part, Boomer, as you just mentioned a few moments ago, is the senior class did not beat Navy in their 4 years. And that's going to be the bitter pill to swallow when you look back on this many, many years from now.
Well, maybe 3 or 4 years from now, we'll hear Bobby Ross talk about this senior class the way Paul Johnson spoke about his first senior class, and that is the transformation begins, and you have to have some leaders that really care, and certainly they'll look back to Zach Tomlin as he runs out of bounds here as a kid that just kept fighting and fighting and fighting and never gave up, and that's exactly what you would expect from an academy kid.
Now for Bobby Ross, you could tell that there was some pride for what they've done this year. Clearly, a 4-7 is not acceptable in his book, but the improvements were made. He thinks these players now understand the effort that's needed to practice with, and that's where it all begins and all starts at these military academies. And even this week, Bobby Ross was trying to find a happy medium with these players as Domin is caught. Unable to break free. Ty Adams makes the play. Let's head back to New York. Tim Brenda.
Boomer, I said he had 185 yards, he being Reggie Bush a moment ago. There's 13 more of his 198 total. 24-0 USC. And you're wondering why I've already sent in my Heisman ballot. It's back to Ian.
All right, Timmy B, thanks very much.
You think Reggie Bush has won the Heisman?
I think he's got it locked up. That's just my opinion. Second and 19 now for the Black Knights. Domin steps up and over the middle to Ulikowski. Gang tackled as he took it to the 45. And for Army, the Black Knights, the Commander-in-Chief's trophy is not coming to West Point.
There's not a worse feeling than sitting on the sideline of a football game that you know you're going to lose with 5 minutes to go in the game, 4 minutes to go now, 4 minutes and 11 seconds, and you know you got to sit through it. It's painful because you put your heart and soul into the game, and as we've been talking about all night, for these kids this game is everything. This means everything to each of these academies, and they have to go back to their academies, and for Army the last 4 years it hasn't been easy.
Domin on a slap to Hill. But if Army can look to any inspiration, Boomer, this Navy program will now be 25-11 over the last three seasons. The previous 3 years, they were a combined 3-30. It can be done.
Well, it certainly can be done. And because Army has left Conference USA and has become an independent, they can kind of tailor their schedule more to their type of athlete, although they did add Notre Dame.
They did next year.
And Bobby Ross, that's great. We want to go to Notre Dame. That's a great program. It's a great old rivalry. That's where we want to go. We want our kids to experience that. So, I mean, they're not backing down from any challenge either.
Oh, Zach Domin just took a shot from behind. David Mahoney came rushing, knocked it loose. And Navy comes out of it with a football.
Well, as I was telling you, at this point in the game, there is no regard for the run if you're a defensive lineman or a linebacker that might be blitzing. And Mahoney comes right around the corner, and Domin never sees him. He certainly doesn't sense him either, as you could see right there by the looks of that hit.
Well, he was down. So Army is going to hold on to it, but it's going to set up second and 17 at the 48. Jones in the backfield, fake the handoff. Domin will throw it, airing it out, and should have been caught by Murphy. Incomplete. Well, now let's check out the CBS Sports Line stat of the game. And what this Navy team has done on the ground, incredible. Owens, 100 yards rushing. Nelson, 82 yards rushing. Ballard, 188 yards rushing. A couple of touchdowns for him. Owens with three touchdowns himself. You can get complete game stats at CBSSportsLine.com.
Well, and Adam Ballard is Adam Ballard. He's not Kyle Echol, and certainly today he proved that. And really, you know, he's getting the opportunity because Hall's injury, and football's a crazy place where you can create your fortune because of somebody else's misfortune, and that's exactly what Ballard's doing. He's making the most of his opportunity.
Well, Navy has set a new record in this series, 472 rushing yards, the most they've ever had against Army, and the sixth most they've had in Navy football history. Now, last year it was Kyle Echol. Actually, the last 2 years, he won the MVP award in this Army-Navy matchup. Craig Candido won it the year before that. And this year, I gotta think Owens is probably gonna come down with that title, yes?
I would think so, because that last run by Ballard basically came when the game was sealed, but, and Owens has been great from the outset.
Dahmann throwing on the move. And hits his man, Walter Hill. It'll be a first down for Army out near the 25-yard line of Navy.
So you want to play quarterback at a major college. He drops back. He's going to roll to his right. And watch Zach Dahmann take this hit right here. Bang. Gets driven into the ground. And you know, the one thing about Zach Dahmann, like we've been talking about, he's been here for 4 years, and he just doesn't stop. The kid's relentless. I'll give him that much. And his numbers... 22 of 34, 237 yards and two touchdowns.
Well, for Dahmann, he has no regrets after his performance in this game. Scott Wesley the run. The Army offense was not the issue today. The Army defense was against Navy and their inability to stop that triple option attack. A minute 36 to go in the fourth. We'll step aside. Navy just moments away from their third straight Commander-in-Chief's trophy.
Life offers a simple formula for long-term success. Protect what really matters. Grow it with care. That's our approach to planning for your future at Prudential Retirement. For decades, we've used our strength to help people and organizations plan for retirement with intelligent retirement solutions designed to both grow wealth and protect it. Growth and protection. The strong and steady approach to retirement at Prudential Financial.
When you can create your own holiday seafood feast, a meal turns into a celebration. Only Red Lobster lets you create your own favorite holiday feast by combining two or three of your seafood favorites. Choose from 10 signature dishes, including our very best sweet and tender snow crab. And remember, this holiday season, you can treat the seafood lovers on your list to a Red Lobster gift card.
Navy 42, Army 17, 1:36 to go here in the fourth quarter. Navy headed off to the Poinsettia Bowl, December 22nd in San Diego against Colorado State, and expecting a huge naval presence for that game.
Well, they travel really well. The Houston Bowl and the Emerald Bowl, both over 20,000 Navy fans travel with the team. So, touchdown by Army, but you know, Navy has got a lot to be proud of, and so does Paul Johnson.
Jeremy Trimble on the touchdown, and Zach Dahmann is going to finish off his collegiate career with a three-touchdown day, although a losing effort against Navy. With a minute and a half to play.
You know, and interesting, we just had a shot of Paul Johnson standing there over the sideline. You were talking about how bad his back was. You could see him grimacing there a little bit, but I'm sure that pain subsides and the smile grows as the game gets closer to the end, as they will now hold on to this baby right here, the Commander-in-Chief's trophy, and this will be the third year in a row, and that will be a Navy record.
Going for two here with Carlton Jones in the backfield. And on the toss to Jones. Not going to get there. DeJuan Price made sure of it. Final 90 seconds in Philly when we return.
Wow, that's beautiful.
Hey, look at that one.
Whoa.
I like that one. That was cool.
The all-new 7-passenger Jeep Commander with available Command View skylights. It's your world. Take command.
It's our Miles of Freedom plan. Now get 2 years of gas and scheduled maintenance and a 5-year or 60,000-mile limited warranty on Jeep Commander.
Navy comfortably in front, 42-23. Army gets the touchdown. Jeremy Trimble, whose dad Steven was a former NFL defensive back with Denver and Chicago. Jeremy's grandfather served in the Air Force. And a sophomore from Ashburn, Virginia, able to haul it in. Second of the day for him, 6 catches, 81 yards for Trimble. And that's something that Army has to think about for next year. Dahman, who has been a 4-year starter, off and on his first 3 years. But David Pivato is a sophomore backup and a big kid, 6'3", 211 pounds, from Collegeville, Texas. And he could be the heir apparent. Onside kick, Navy handles it. Mick Yokaitis, the senior from Pittsburgh, able to haul it in. Our play of the game presented by Wrangler 5-star premium denim jeans, Lamar Owens, and this one was simply sensational. You think he's down? Think again. Owens, 28-yard touchdown run for Navy. And our Wrangler 5-star play of the game. We'll see our third quarterback of the day for the Naval Academy, Joe Taylor. He's a freshman from Warsaw, Virginia. And Taylor carrying it to the 40-yard line of Army. SEC Championship coming up next. Number 13, Georgia, taking on the number 3 team in the country, LSU. That's coming up. The SEC Championship on CBS. Well, for Adam Ballard and the rest of the Navy midshipmen, they're going to remember this one, remember it. And another year, they'll do it all over again with Army hoping for different results. Down to 48 seconds left.
There's one happy Lamar Owens. I mean, what a terrific football game. 488 yards rushing, fifth most in school history. And you know, that's how you want to win a game. And you control that line of scrimmage and you put up this type of point number, 42. That's an emphatic statement that you are not where we are at this point. And Navy has to be proud of their accomplishments today.
Final seconds here for Navy. The first senior class that was recruited by Paul Johnson. And they will complete the sweep. The seniors finish off 4-0 against Army, as Navy has won the Commander-in-Chief's Trophy here in 2005. 42-23. Paul Johnson's Navy midshipman knocking off Bobby Ross and the Black Knights of Army. Navy now 7-4. Army 4-7. The 106th meeting between these two rivals belongs to Navy. And they take the lead in the all-time series with a mark now of 50-49-7. First time they have led the all-time series in 14 years. Just the fourth time a senior class has swept Army with a mark of 4-0. Army's 4-game winning streak comes to an end. As for Navy, they've got one more to play. December 22nd in San Diego the first ever poinsettia bowl as they take on Colorado State. And as always, it is tradition. The losing team faces their fellow cadets in the stands. Players from both teams stand at attention. The alma mater is played first for Army. And now the midshipmen make their way to the other end of the field. And we are ready for the Navy alma mater. Navy has done it again. For Boomer Esiason and Dwayne Ballin, this is Ian Eagle. So long from Philadelphia. Navy wins it 42-23. SEC championship is coming up. Georgia against LSU. This has been a presentation of CBS Sports.
Happy anniversary.
There's an exciting new sound in travel. Introducing Ding. Get exclusive low fares sent directly to your desktop. Download it at southwest.com.